Hello, hello, hello. Jen's rubber band broke in her hair. She had to run in real quick and change her rubber band. She'll be out in a second. So I'm just taking up space while we wait for her. Hello, hello, Don Forker. Hello, Nicole. Hello, perfectly imperfect. Hi, Miss Ladybug. Hi, Marianne. Fergie's Chords, hello. Be kind, hello. Nitty G, what's going on? All right, I think she's back. Good afternoon, Avery Roar. Hello, Michael. Yeah, Jen had a hairdrobe malfunction. What's up, Amber B. Bye. Hello. Jennifer H., what's going on?
Hello.
Your shirt is cool. I know, it is. Who's this made by?
Sad Girl Designs.
Sad Girl Designs. Sad Girl Designs. Pretty darn cool. I like the turtle on it. He's cute. Ordered my Tumblr back in July. Coming soon. I would expect that it is. Which one is it? Because we cut off taking orders in like mid-August. So all that's left are the ones that Jen had that she's working on. And those ones should be coming to an end here in the next 2 weeks or so.
Yep.
Thank you, Envious. I love the shirt, too. Let's see. Okay. So, hello, Dawn Bumba. There's Jen. She's going to take over now, and I'm going to get out of the way.
Thank you. Thank you. All that?
Yeah.
Hello, hello, hello. My rubber band popped right as I was just getting ready to go on live. And a hairdrobe malfunction. I don't know what that is. I'm gonna weed this real quick. Decal it real quick. So we can get it epoxied and out. Hello. Hey, William, how are ya? Hello. Hairdrobe, yeah. Instead of a wardrobe, it's a hairdrobe. Hairdrobe malfunction. That's what I said when it popped. I'm like, oh my God, I had a hairdrobe malfunction. Hello, hello. How is everybody tonight?
Miranda says, hey, hey, turtle fam.
Hey, girl, hey.
Pegleg Racer says, hey, hey, turtles.
Hello, how are you? Pegleg Racer, I love that. Cracks me up. Cracks me up. Envious Benjamin, hello! You guys had an awesome day today. I took a nap, and it was one of those naps, because I don't get naps very often, like almost never. I always try to take a nap. It never happens. Why does this look weird? It looks weird. Okay. I think that filter was flipped. And it was one of those naps where I got in such a good sleep. I didn't want to wake up. I just wanted to keep sleeping. I was like, we can do the live tomorrow. So good. Now I feel like I have a bunch of pent-up energy. Not bad Thursday, Turtles and Seahawks football. Keep us posted on the score. You got a nap right before the live too, see? Sometimes, man, I was so tired, I couldn't keep my eyes open. I just couldn't. I was like, oh my God, I gotta get some sleep. I gotta get some sleep.
I'm tweaking into a whole new era.
I ran into my heat press today. Ouch. Ouch. It's like a split second, too. That's all it took. Split second.
Okay. Rocky Morning Boutique says, hey, Miss Ladybug says I slept most all day with NyQuil.
Hello, Jeannie. Who was up with NyQuil?
Miss Ladybug.
Aww.
Leanne says, just spilled a bottle of craft paint all over my work area.
How many F-bombs were just dropped? You slept most of the day with NyQuil. I thought you said you didn't sleep because of NyQuil, because I get wired from NyQuil.
Hey, it's KK says hello, hello.
Hello.
Amber V. Bye says, I need that cup. PC Witness says, hi, Turtle Fam.
Is that not amazing?
Paulina Williams says, hey. Avery Lohr says, cute cup, Jen. Fossil Babe, thank you very much for those gifts. That'll get you entered into our drawing for our October gifters.
Thank you
very
much.
To win a free 20-ounce custom tumbler of your choice.
Look at all those roses. You guys are way cool. So we need to totally hit the For You page tonight. So I need you guys to start tapping. We're going to have some tap wars. If you don't know with our tap wars, if you get the high score of the night, you get an entry into a gifter winner.
Marianne says she did that.
It hurts. It's a split second at 312 degrees or whatever. Didn't take much for a split second. Just need a soft one to get around the edges. All right. You guys remember our black flame that we did? We did the glue drip on it. So I put this fluorescent glow in the dark purple underneath this one. Because the rest of it's going to be black. And it's gonna glow purple, so it's gonna be really cool. So we're just gonna paint around the edges of it, and then we'll be able to black out the rest of it, spray paint the rest of it.
Kel's Custom Craft says, hi everyone.
Hello, how are you?
Tatted Thick Chick says, pouring resin right now, tap in a minute, LOL.
Jen, Tatted Thick Chick is
Jen. With an extra N.
Two N's.
J-E-N-N.
Because, you know, for a while I went with two N's, because, you know, there's two N's in Jennifer. And I thought, why not? Because most people didn't. And then I was just like, I got lazy. And I was like, fuck it. Just one end works. Gets the point across. I get called Jan more than anything. Which is fun, you know. Like Brady Bunch Jan.
Corey said this song goes along with your conversation from yesterday.
Yeah. Right?
Georgian J86 says, love the look of that cup.
Thank you. Yeah, it's going to be super cool. We're going to spray paint it here. We're just blacking out the edges so we can spray paint the rest of it black. I don't want to get too close to my decal when I paint. So we're just going to black it out, and then it's going to glow purple. I didn't do a purple one before, so I thought, why not? We were just making the extra. I thought we had one that was for an oversold double sale. But we got those all out, so I thought, well, let's just
Vanessa
turn this
Horton
into this.
Says that is so beautiful.
Thank you. It's gonna be really cool. I think. I think we'll show you the purple glow in a second.
Brumbaugh said you don't even look like a Jen.
I know, right? Like, I don't know if I look like a Jen either, but I certainly don't look like a Jan. Just think that's weird. Like.
Avery Lohr said, hurry, get the taps in before Ryan gets here.
Yes.
Stacy Peek says, I
Poor
love
Sean
that.
Gets on, too.
Sean's already on.
Is he already on?
I
oh,
think
shit,
he's the one
he's
that's
tapping. Yeah. All right. If those of you haven't started the tap war and you're ready to start, I'll give you a 1, 2, 3, go. Oh. Make sure you screenshot it. You got to email it over to me, and it'll get you an entry into the drawing.
George so, Luis Diaz says, how much are these?
The cups range anywhere from like 45 and up, depending on size and design. My custom orders are currently closed right now, but they're going to be opening back up pretty soon. So stay tuned. Give me a follow.
William.
Because we'll announce it on here first when orders are open. Anybody who's reached out to us, we'll reach out to them too.
William, U.S. Navy vet, says, I got to meet up with Russ today and got the Lego sets I won.
Oh, fantastic. fantastic. Koya's gonna be meeting him too. She's gonna be handing him his tumbler. So I'm really excited. We got the Legos on it. I didn't have all the right Legos to make a handle. So he's gonna have to make his own handle, but he can make it on either side, left-handed, right-handed, whichever way he wants to do it. So it's gonna be, hey girl. So it's gonna be really cool. I can't wait. And I just got her t-shirt.
Bish, please.
Well, that's why I burnt myself, is on Koya's t-shirt.
Does that mean you found a house?
No, not yet. Okay.
All right, so we're gonna finish painting this black, but I wanted to show you guys this glow because it's way cool. So let's do that real quick before I make too much of a mess. Can you hit that, the light?
Yep.
I can't reach it. Tip over. So this will be it'll be a purple glow. Go ahead. Isn't that awesome? Okay. Isn't that way cool? Ah!
Drink!
All over. So it's gonna be really cool. So we're gonna Bernie black
says,
out the rest of it.
Good evening, all.
Hello, hello.
Crimson Misfit Multi Palm says, hey, hey.
Hello. I'm just using up the last of
Bernie
my
said,
rest of black
cool.
paint.
Stacy Peek said, oh my God. Fish Please said, beautiful.
This very possibly could be a giveaway cup on a live coming up sometime between now and Halloween. So make sure you're following me. That way you can get notified when I go live, because we are going to be giving this one away at some point, because I don't believe it needs to go to an order. I didn't see any more black flames. It was an extra one made.
Amber Beby says, I'm colorblind. It was blue.
I see a bluish purple hue on it. So we're going to finish spray painting this up. Then we're going to seal it really good with epoxy. It's going to be amazing.
Daza says, hey, my turtle fam bam.
Hello, hello.
Tanya Nepp says, Jen, you're awesome. So cool.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. All right. Water.
Rush. Oh,
shit. George Luis Diaz says, I must have one.
It's pretty cool. It is pretty cool.
Mom of Three says, what state are you in?
Charlotte, North Carolina. You didn't ask for the city, but I told you anyways.
Stacy Peek says, my daughter's a huge Hocus Pocus fan. I wish I could buy one.
They're super cute. I know there's like every tumbler maker out there is making them. So if you can't find it, stay tuned, because we're going to be giving this one away. Not tonight. Maybe. Depends on how many people we get in here. If we can get a bunch of people in here, we might give it away tonight. We have another cup to give away too, Mr. Tiwi. We were supposed to talk about that earlier and I completely forgot.
Chris Chick says hi, hi.
Hello, hello.
Carrie White Lafferty says hello, hello, hello.
I have to do some glittering and some spray painting.
Don Brumbaugh says,
glittering and
my kid loved her black flame. I couldn't wait until Christmas.
You are too funny. You are just like me. That's the reason why I stopped buying Christmas presents. I used to try to get all my Christmas shopping done like kind of before October and then hit Black Friday sales, actually Cyber Monday sales, hardcore. My mom and I used to do Black Friday sales. And then I was like, you know what? I keep buying all this stuff intended for Christmas, but I don't really like surprises myself if I know I have a surprise. If I'm not aware of it and I get something, I'm like, oh, I love that. But I don't like somebody saying, hey, I have a surprise for you, and then I have to wait like 3 months for it. Kills me. It kills me. So I end up just giving it to my kids way ahead of time. And
Danielle
then I have to buy more for
Christmas. Says hello.
Hello.
Marina Leo says, I love your cup with the roses and spider webs. How much?
Isn't it way cool? I didn't make this. This was made by, let me pull her name out. It's another Jennifer. Jennifer, is it Lynn? Jennifer, hold on. It's right here.
Julie Lynn.
No.
Isn't it?
No, Jenny Lynn.
Jenny Lynn.
I got it right. Jenny Lynn. Jenny Lynn, what's your business name? I don't have that on here.
Briz
I don't have
Chick,
it on here.
Briz Chick said,
I got your
Jen,
I got your
can
cute
you show me your name and
star
sign?
Sticker board. Oh, so it's this side. I used to have a beauty mark here, and it was very much like Cindy Crawford's. It was really dark brown. It's faded over the years. I don't really know where it's went. It's gone. But anyways, it used to just be the J-E-N. That's how they, and then just J for Jen.
And how did Grizz Chick show you to do it?
She did it just the J female side. Yeah.
And that's what she was asking.
Yeah, but this was the J with the beauty mark.
Carrie White Lafferty, beauty. I got my cup. Thank you. The colors
are
amazing.
I'm going to relearn sign language again. It's been so long. I loved it. But this is from Jenny Lynn, and I don't know what her business name is. And if she's on here, there you go. Refined Vessels. There she is. Refined Vessels. She's got her name, Jenny Lynn 67. Click on her. Go follow her. She made this amazing. She makes a good witch one too, but I mean, really, who's that? And this is amazing. I asked for purple and silver. She's just done them in a bunch of colors. It's very elegant and classy, like me. And
sorry, I didn't mean to laugh.
It's my jam. This is totally
True Designs for you, Tracy says, hey, turtle fan.
Hello, hello. So you need to, she's commenting, she's in here. Go check her out. Order one of these cups from her. Get her so busy that she's got a, 6 to 8 week turnaround time, because you guys need one of these. It
Marina
is
Leo
stunning.
Says, yes, it's awesome. Thank you.
Like, smoke perfect.
Tiny Nep, it's beautiful.
Nicole Peekaboo Cumbie, perfect. Vinyl perfect.
Mr. T is going to end up in the doghouse. I'm always
you know
in
what?
The doghouse.
He gets out of the doghouse so easy because I keep buying tumblers from other tumbler makers, and I don't tell them about it until they get here.
Grizz Chick said I reached out to a couple people about interpreting.
Excellent. I would, how do you guys, what do you guys totally think it would be cool if we invited a guest sign language interpreter that could be a guest in here, and she'd be in that little box, and while we're going, she could interpret and sign for folks. I would love to kind of include, or at least make our hearing impaired community feel more included. So if you guys think that's a pretty cool idea, I wish we could have subtitles during lives, but that's not an option. So if that's something you guys would love to have, I think it would be amazing.
Oaks Pack says, hey, turtle fam. Corey says, yes.
Hello. Right? I think it would be amazing.
Kath XO90 says, my Tumblr was sent on the 5th. Thank you so much. I can't wait to see it. Tanya Nep said, that would be awesome. Nicole Cumbie said, that would be awesome. True Design says, I like that idea.
Yeah.
Miranda, that would be so awesome.
Daniel
Manlove says, I think you should do that.
Yeah. And I think it's kind of neat that TikTok has incorporated some things to kind of help with our hearing impaired, so that there's some subtitles and you can do videos and caption your videos and stuff. And I try to remember to do that as often as I can, but I forget. I'm terrible at it. But I think there's not a lot for lives. There should be some captioning for lives. It might be weird because we've all seen their caption translates on videos and it's not great.
Perfectly Imperfect says, what would you recommend to someone wanting to start a tumbling business?
I would recommend that you start off with some supplies that you are excited and comfortable with, and learn a technique or two that you are really excited about, and become really good at those. And while you're making those and you haven't become really good at them yet, those are amazing gifts for friends and family. And as your friends and family start to see these gifts that you're getting, and they start to see you getting better and better at it, they're going to want more. And then you can kind of start charging your friends and family and say, hey, look, I got at least have to charge the cost of supplies. Then you need to start including your time and labor in it. When you start building that kind of support from your friends and family, start posting online when you're ready to go like full on sale. I don't recommend anybody picking up a tumbler for their first time and making it to sell.
Paula
Williams.
You need
to practice. You need to get good at a technique.
Where did you get the straw topper?
They actually have these available. I've actually ordered some. They're going to go in for our sub boxes. They're silicone straw. I can't remember what they're called. Not extenders. Not toppers. Silicone straw sleep. Tips.
Megan Gilly says iPhone
sleep
has
tips.
Captioning, but it's trash.
Yeah,
because,
it's...
Of course. Megan, you know sign language, don't you?
Do you know sign language, Megan?
Yeah, because of her daughter.
Oh, I would love to have... I mean, I'm going to need more than one person because I can't ask somebody to totally commit to doing it on every one of our lives, especially for 2 hours.
We would never know what she's saying, though. That might be dangerous with Megan.
That's true. Yeah, there's a code of ethics with signing.
Sparking
I think they're tips.
Says,
I think they're silicone straw tips. Ask Jenny Lynn. She gets them. I got an awesome straw with it. I was so excited. She gave me a plastic straw, which is totally cool. But because it's reusable, we use them for our little drinks, and then my grandkids use the reusable straws all the time. But I like the metal ones. And
Chris Chick said, "What are you drinking?"
What did you make me?
It's cherry vodka, mango vodka, and Red Bull.
There you go. I had a killer Kool-Aid earlier, but I need something with Red Bull to get me going. I need to wake up.
Yeah, see? Vanessa Horton, I want a cup like that. Don Forker, signing with Sammy is amazing at signing.
Incredible. We just thought about this when she signed for, she did a duet in my video, and she signed in it, and I was like, oh, I took 2 years in college, and that was like 25 years ago. I remember very, very little, very little. And I wanted to start picking it up because I really wanted to teach my grandkids. But I just haven't had the time. And she did the signing. I was like, oh my God. So I watched the video 100 times just so I could see how she signed. Jen, that's beautiful. It was awesome. And so then we started talking back and forth. And it's something that I would really, really love to do. Nah, I do have a half-time husband. Seven
says, hey, Turtle Fam.
Hello. Dorothy, so we're working on a...
Dorothy Seven says, happy Thursday. It's almost the weekend.
Spark
Up Your Life says, I have a degree in ASL, but it would make my head explode to try and keep up with this pace.
Oh, right. I would like to go back and take some more of it, though. All right, guys, we need to start tapping. We only have 127 people in here, and we're usually close to 200 by now. So let's start tapping and sharing. Tapping and sharing. We need to hit the For You page. This is going to be a Tumblr that we're going to be doing. This is going to be one of the ones. This is the start of one that we're going to be giving away on Saturday. I'm going to see if you guys can start to guess what it might be.
Barb Duggan says, hello, Turtle People.
I got to get the first step of it done so it's ready for
Barb, Saturday. I sent you an email today, so check your emails, please.
Alexa, next.
Megan Gilly says, I do. Definitely a code of ethics.
Yeah. There's
Zero says, hey, everyone.
Hello. It is a very big, I was incredibly honored to get my sign name given to me. I was working, I was taking classes in college, I was taking the ASL, and this was when my oldest was little, and I was working at a restaurant, and I was bartending at the time. And while I was bartending, I was practicing my sign language because you learn about 500 new signs a week, and that's a lot, especially when you're a mom of a baby, and trying to remember anything at that point is insane. And so I was practicing a lot at
work. Everybody's saying pumpkin is what you're making with that.
It's gonna be pumpkin something.
How do you guys know that? Now, come on.
Right, it's just orange.
Oh, because you have orange paint.
Yeah.
Duh.
And so I was practicing, and then I found out that we have a couple that was coming in. They were regulars, and they were coming in, and what they used to do is they used to just hand the server their written order. And when I found out that they used to come in and sit, I would go over there and I would practice with them and ask them if they would mind me. I was learning, and I put that on the wrong hand. I was learning, and do they mind if I try to take their order and try to help them? And they loved it. And then they started sitting at the bar with me, and they helped me for months. But they're the ones that gave me my name sign. I get a little teary-eyed when I think about it because it was very special.
Everybody, a lot of people are saying pumpkin, jack-o'-lantern.
A pumpkin zombie. I love that idea, though. That's pretty cool.
Let's see here. Bugs here, I'm so excited. Dorothy Seven says, if you haven't started my cup yet, I'm not sure if I asked for fine glitter.
Oh.
Generally, the glitter Jen uses is probably going to be...
Yeah, and it's what's best for the design.
Right. Because unless you ask for chunky glitter...
It's usually going to be a fine chunky glitter mix, but it just depends on the design. So if it's something I think looks better with a specific mask, yes, thank you. So this one is actually going to be our wine glass. It's going to be our peekaboo. It's not really going to be a peekaboo. It's going to be one of those. Remember how we did the watermelon and we scuffed away some of it and exposed the underneath? We're going to put little white pumpkin seeds in on it. And we're going to have this really amazing orange glitter that's in their Marine Life series, Clownfish by Blackbear Glitters.
Barb Duggan said surprise her, so make her anything she wants.
Seriously? Yeah. Oh, yes! Okay, I'm so excited. I know exactly what I want to do, too. So I have a design in mind. So we're going to do that with this. We're going to make it a pumpkin. And we're even going to, when we spray paint the outside, we're going to try to get some darker color variation in there so we kind of have that whole pumpkin feel. But I think it's going to be super cute. And then we'll rub away some, expose that
Amber
glitter.
Amber Bevi said, I thought about taking classes, but there's so many people that pretend to know for money. It's sad.
Yeah. No, I went to the community college and took it. I got all the way through, I learned how to sign a song and
it's
everything.
The only
I was
language
really
that's
good
universal.
At it.
Yeah, she did The River by Garth Brooks.
No, I did.
I thought it was The River. Oh, no, it was.
We Are the World. What's the.
We Will Be Strong.
We will be free.
We Will Be Free.
By Garth Brooks.
God almighty.
So I'm spray
that was so
painting
long ago.
Glittering.
Spray mask. Painting. Everybody's saying mask. Mask, Jen, mask. Mask.
You're right.
Michael said 4.2K likes.
Woo! That's a lot. All right, guys. 4.2. See if anybody's getting more than that. Completely forgot my mask and this paint stinks.
AmyU172 says, hey.
Hello. I forgot to open my glitter.
Bish Please says, mask. Everybody's saying mask.
I know. I completely forgot. Terrible. I'm so good. I'm
Megan
so
says
good
it's not
day,
universal,
usually.
Has accents. British isn't the same. Every language and area has its own.
It does, but it's American, the ASL, the American Sign Language, is one of the most widely used around
now,
the world.
Now remember, you're talking to an expert
few.
Because
but,
she
yeah.
has a half-deaf husband well, yeah. and a...
There's so this was 20 some years ago
that
I learned about all this. So I'm sure a lot has changed.
Her stepdaughter.
I mean, I'm ancient.
Caitlin ancient. Rose, I don't claim to be fluent in sign, but I know some. I wish more people would learn it.
I do too.
Dogboy Brewery says hello, turtle fam.
I actually think it should be taught in an elementary school.
Where's Megan?
God, that glitter is gorgeous, guys. Do you see that?
Mama Bear says, hi, guys.
Hi, guys. Look.
Reggie Mama says, hello, turtle fam.
Look.
That glitter is gorgeous.
It's gorgeous. This is clownfish.
Nana's Tumblr says, good
gorgeous?
Evening.
That is beautiful. That's going to be gorgeous as a rub away. I mean, that sparkle.
Jamaica Sherry says, pretty.
Love it.
Oaks Peak says, I would love to learn it. I know the alphabet.
I do remember most of the alphabet.
Amber Bebi says, is that glass?
It is. That is glass. That's why I was really careful with my little tiny hammer. Didn't want to break it.
Mama Bear says, I recognize that glitter.
Yeah. We're making it.
Megan says ASL definitely translates to most well enough to get by.
Yeah.
And there's not many languages out there that translate well enough to get by.
Just about anywhere, yeah.
I think everybody should have to learn it.
All right, guys, we've got 171 people in here. We're getting really close to the number we need to get to give away at least one tumbler tonight.
Dogboy Brewery says, she's right here with me. Hi, Megan, we miss you. We need to see your robot. You need to pop on and do your robot for us. Blue-Eyed Gemini says, my son is learning... my son is learning it in high school.
That's fantastic. I really think if we taught all our kids in elementary school, that they would remember it forever. I think they would just stick with
it. Anthony Z's wife says, I'm trying to get Mr. Turtle to see me. I see you.
We see you.
Did I miss a comment somewhere?
Maybe. Probably. Okay.
KT Kool-Aid says,
this is gorgeous.
Ooh, that orange is nice.
It is beautiful. Beautiful. Clownfish. Bud
Beggins says, very pretty.
Thirsty Turtle for 15%
Mysterious
off the order.
Storm says, hello.
This is stunning. It's got like a, it's almost a shift because it's got a gold orange.
Bernie says, so pretty.
Depending on how you look at it, you get a lot of gold and then you get a lot of orange. See how it, like,
Kayla Marie.
Sometimes like it's dark orange here.
Keith
and then
says,
you get this gold kind
it.
Of pop out.
Koya's Craft Box says, hey, Turtle Crew.
Hello, hello.
Amy Yu says, I use ASL in my class with my students.
See, I think the more teachers that know it, the better we could be. Because I think if teachers just signed while they talked, kids would just pick it up. They would just pick it up. And that's all they would know is,
Dog
I mean,
Boy,
I just think to me it would be amazing.
Dogboy Brewery asks, are we going to the GC Spring Retreat? Because they are. That's the one in Vegas, right?
Yeah. It's June though, right? I know it's almost sold out. I really want to go. I haven't been to Vegas, and we got friends in Vegas, and we're gonna try. I was telling him, I said, I looked how much it was, I can get a room. We used to get free rooms.
Oaks Pack says, do we share to individuals? Okay, so Oaks Pack, anybody that you're following currently, that you're friends with, that have followed you back, if you look at the bottom right of your screen, there's a forwarding arrow. If you click on that, it'll pull up all the people that you may want to forward to.
I'm getting ready to cut your... I'm going to make a pineapple on your tumbler. We're going to cut little shapes and glue them on and Mod Podge over them and then glitter
them. Tanya Knepp says, love that orange.
And paint them. And it's going to look like an actual pineapple.
Koya's Craftbox says, I
taught RJ. Are you cool with that? I'm even thinking a pineapple topper. You taught RJ Sign Language?
By ASL.
See? I think it's really... And I think babies learn it. So it's like, I just think it should be... The more people that know it, the more people that use it, the more people are going to learn it.
Bish Please says, I had a deaf best friend until ninth
grade. It sounds amazing.
So I'm a
okay, good.
Rusty on sign language.
Because I really
want
to make it.
Grandma of Four says, I love that. Caitlin Rose says, that's part of the reason I'd like to learn more.
Me too. I just.
Kayla Marie Keith says, I love watching y'all.
I'd hate to exclude somebody. Like, I understand. Like, I tried my best wherever I'm at. Like, when we moved to Florida, there was a lot of Spanish. So I tried to learn as much Spanish. And there's a lot of variations because I used to have a lot of people work with me from different denominations, from Dominican to Cuban to everywhere. So
Haitian.
Right. So there's different dialects that come with them. So I started to learn a little more. Because I never want anybody that's around to feel left out or
Kayla Marie
not Keith. Able to be in the moment because of communication.
Kayla
so,
Marie Keith says they don't even teach cursive anymore. My 15-year-old doesn't even know how to sign her name. Sad.
They said we could cripple an entire generation if we just go back to cursive and stick shift. Everybody like below the age of 25 would be just screwed.
Pineapple Lady 78 says, hi, how are you?
Hi. That's what I was telling her. I'm going to make her a pineapple. I'm actually
Caitlin
making
Rose
her a pineapple.
Says, I'm trying to teach my niece and nephew the alphabet and sign language.
It's way cool. And there's amazing videos. And there are, I follow several on here because I love watching them sign songs and sign. I just love it. I find it fascinating. And if I'm ever at a live event and there's an interpreter, I'm always watching them. I'm just fascinated. I love it. I think that would be, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Megan says International Online Academy has a decent online ASL course for those who are wondering.
There you go, guys. Check it out. I'm going to have to write that down. Well, you said it out loud, so I'll get it in the replay.
And that's from a mama who has a little girl who just had a cochlear implant put in. So she would know.
Yeah.
That's coming from...
Is it a subscription base or is it free or... Because I totally want to do it. I totally want to learn more.
Okay. Heather, I'm not exactly sure what that UHHITS is. It's Heather. It's Heather. I got it.
I got a dump cup.
She says, I love your guys' lives.
I got a dump cup coming up. This one was requested for that. We did a rainbow cup and she wanted that.
Barb Duggan said she had to step away. What was the name of that orange glitter?
It is clownfish. I know it's backwards. Sorry. Clownfish.
Alyssa Osling says, hi, my favorite turtle
it's
fam.
Stunning. That thing is going to be under epoxy.
Scrappy Girl says, I'll be in and out. I'm at Disney.
Way cool. What do you want here for? Go enjoy Mickey.
Kaylee Lee Denmark says, what time is it there?
I don't know, like 9:30?
Yeah, about 9:30 p.m. So for you, it's like 1:30, what? 1:30?
No, 2:30. 9:30 should be about 2:30 there.
2:30 your time in Denmark?
Am I right?
How do you seal a glass wine? How do you seal the glass wine glass?
I'm gonna epoxy right over it.
Scrambled Meg says, "Hey."
Hello. You can epoxy him. It's gonna go on my turner just like this. Well, I'm going to straighten it out. There we go. So it spins even. And I'm going to put epoxy right over that. And then on Saturday, you're going to see us do more on this. And this is going to be one of our tumblers we're giving away.
Alex Grover says, do you have an Etsy?
No, I don't.
We're anti-Etsy.
Not anti-Etsy. I just think it's ridiculous how much they collect in fees anti-Etsy. When you can have a website and still have like credit card processing fees and all that and pay so much less. But it is a selling platform, and it's an amazing selling platform because that's where people go to look for stuff. It's kind of like eBay when it first came out. But I just don't like how they take, you sell something for $15 and you walk away with $5 because they took $10 of it for fees. I just don't think that's very supportive of the small business.
Jennifer A. says,
amazing.
I only know the basics as I had a friend who used sign language.
Awesome.
Dog Boy Brewery says, we taught the girls baby sign language. It helped a lot with communication when they couldn't speak.
I think so too. I think their little brains are absorbing it and they just haven't formed
it becomes second
ability
nature.
To actually form words. So to be able to sign, they get motor skills.
Our daughter-in-law was doing that with our granddaughter because she was 2 years old and didn't want to speak. It's not that she couldn't, she just didn't want to.
Her brother went off to school, and guess what?
She started speaking in full sentences.
Started talking up a storm.
Miss Diamond says, not true. I teach second grade, and I teach cursive. A lot of schools don't anymore.
Yeah.
So it just depends on the curriculum, but I know.
You gotta know how to sign your name, right?
Our baby turtle didn't learn sign language until...
Cursive
until like eighth grade. And they only spent like 2 weeks on it.
Yeah, it was very little.
Mr. Turtle, have you seen my question? Anthony Z's wife, I don't think I have.
Oh, no. Are you ignoring her? We just got her in here.
Randa says, hey, hey, from Babe Girl and I.
This was a dumb cup request from a very specific tumbler we did. It was a rainbow tumbler. And so this is the buildup of my rainbows. So we're doing a dumb cup with it.
Anthony Z's wife just... find me as a user or, you know, click on my name here. I'll just say hi. Click on my name and send me the message that way so I don't miss it.
Isn't that gorgeous?
Aren't you guys ex-military? You can get great discounts at Caesars Group Hotel in Vegas. Yep, I'm ex-military.
Yeah, that's true. We didn't think about that. We used to get it free because we used to go up to the casino here all the time.
Barb Duggan says, I can't find that glitter. They want to know what the glitter name is again, and it's at Black Bear Glitter.
Glitter Dealer BBG.
Glitter Dealer BBG.
They're in here. Mama Bear's in here, and I think Papa Bear's even in here. They're in here. It is clownfish. It is part of their marine life collection. It just launched and sold out on a live. So they may not have it listed yet until they get their supply in because it's sold out on the live.
Did you find your Jack Daniels decal? She found a Jack Daniels decal a while ago because she made a Jack Daniels cup that shipped about a week ago.
Yeah.
Nettie G says, looks like vanilla confetti cake. Bish Please says, my daughter is 2.5, taught her sign language at 1 year old. She knew more. Eat, please, drink, and all done.
Yeah. Well, I have, my niece was had some delayed speech. So she was taught sign language.
Delayed speech? She didn't speak until she was like
four.
Five.
Yeah.
Almost.
She went into kindergarten and was signing. And they had a little girl that came into the kindergarten that was also hearing impaired. And the teacher didn't know sign language. And so my niece started signing for her. And then before I knew it, because the teacher didn't understand the sign, so my niece just started talking and translating for the other little girl, and that's really the first time she started to talk. I think it's amazing. It's an amazing tool to have, and I think as an adult, it's even better to have. So if you can learn it as a kid, and keep it as a part of your life, I think it's
Avery
incredible.
Roar, Ryan Fearing, all of you that are saying thank you for my service. I appreciate it. It makes me feel awkward when people say that because I'm of the mindset that if you live in this country, everybody should serve at least 2 years. And I know a lot of you won't like that, but you want to be a real true patriot, go shed some blood for the country. And I'm not trying to belittle anybody.
That's just my mindset.
I think it creates a whole new level of patriotism, and it would bring this country together. But I'm going to move on. But you're welcome. I enjoyed my time serving a lot.
He would have stayed in for life, really. But I got really sick, and unfortunately, the healthcare, the doctors that I needed, they didn't have close by in the military, so we were not able to.
Oaks Pack says my husband hates to be thanked also. It's tough.
It's just a hard.
Because most of us that serve just think that that's the normal thing we should do.
But you know what? You need to tell your servicemen thank you for their service. You need to tell their family members thank you for their sacrifice and service.
Alyssa Osling says my husband gets awkward too.
They serve too. They may not be enlisted, but they serve.
Nicola Dawn Blackmore says, hi, how are you doing today?
Hello.
Oaks Pack said hubby did 16 years in the Army Guard and the Reserves.
Fantastic.
Is that glue you're spraying on there? Sabrina Mills, Zanich.
Clear glass. Zanich. I'm using it as my adhesive.
Zanicky.
What? I missed the name.
Sabrina Mills Zanicky.
Love that. This is so interesting because the previous rainbow dump cup that I had was very yellow. And this has much more of a lighter gold green and sparkle of colors to it.
Alyssa, you are 100%.
See that?
Everybody that's a family member of a service member also sacrifices a ton.
Absolutely.
Because believe me, I left Jen at home with an 8-month-old baby while I went off to Somalia. Well, a 2-month-old baby, not even 8 months.
Two months.
While I went off to Somalia for six months.
Actually, he's only a month old. You stayed home from your 3-week to Palm Springs and then had
Puerto
to leave
Rico.
To go to, oh, that's right, Puerto Rico. And then you had to leave to go to Somalia. So he was not even, he was just a month old. And then I got really, really sick. Like, really sick.
Yep, Oaks Pack says, hubby didn't meet our firstborn until he was 3 months old. Aaron Summer says, thank you for your
For your
recognition.
I just dumped a whole thing of dumb cup glitter.
I do one weekend a month.
Oh, it's all over.
It's so hard for everyone to say goodbye and not know it's that will be the last time you see them. I know. And we don't leave. Jen's crying right now because she dumped a whole dumb cup. Well, the good thing is you got most of that cup glittered.
It was a different dumb cup.
Oh, no. Whose was it?
My Rolls Goldfish. It is all over.
She dumped a dump cup.
It is all, oh my God. It is stuck on my.
Shelly's not going to be able to clean that up.
It is stuck on my tape.
Anthony Z's wife says, okay, I give up. I'm done.
Are you not getting through, or are we not getting them? Are we not seeing them?
I'm not seeing it.
Leave the live, come back in. Because sometimes it just is weird when it, because it'll filter out weird shit sometimes. I was in a live the other day, and none of my comments were going through. I was like, what the, I can't believe I did that.
Anthony Z's wife, I just went up like, I don't know, 100 comments, and I see no comment from you.
That one heads on. Woo whoop. Damn it. Oh my God.
Grizz Chick says use the turtle vacuum. Well, that's Shelly, but unfortunately, I don't think that's going to work in there.
Well.
Custom Designs by Chastity says I love that tie-dye shirt on you.
It bounced. Thank you. It bounced on the table.
Wait a minute. I've been doing that and it's not doing anything. Okay, I saw that one. Cajun Lady says, hey, how are y'all? Aaron Summer says, take a breath. Valerie Y says, they might be saying a word that TikTok is flagging and
flagging.
Blocking.
Yeah, it's really weird. I went back through and it's all over my chair. Oh, I'm going to have glitter on my butt.
Kathy RN, just grab a bunch of bottles and create another one from scratch.
You know, good thing is it wasn't actually for somebody's dump cup. but it was such a beautiful mix.
Amber V. Bice
says
someone's,
I wanted to save
someone's dump cup shipment is delayed.
Yeah, right? You'll be getting an email shortly. No, I'm just kidding. Actually, that might have been Michael's. No, I got his.
Mandy Brooks says, want to know if you did or not. Did or not what, Mandy Brooks? Wait a minute. I think I see it. You said, really? And I don't...
I did find the Jack Daniels. Or where did I find them?
Where did you find... Is that what you're asking?
I'm not exactly sure.
Where did you find the Jack Daniels decaf?
I got the coffee and cannabis one and the Jack Daniels one together on a file from Etsy.
Papa Bear says, why do I chuckle when Jen has spillage?
Yeah, chuckle? What are you talking about? I'm going to need refills now.
Caitlin Rose says, love the Halloween decorations. Kendra says, I'm so sorry for you, LOL. Tamika says, think you missed my question, but did you paint the cup white before the glitter?
No, I didn't. I actually painted it orange. Wait, which one? Oh, that cup. Yes, it had a base paint of a very light coat of base paint. It's not even... My base paints, when I go to base a cup, I don't go for solid full coverage. I just go for a nice white because when I go to design it, I may decide to go from white and change and make it a black base. Or I may decide I'm gonna glitter the whole thing anyway so it doesn't matter, or it's gonna get a red base. So I don't wanna waste all that primer paint, but what I do is I wanna give it a good solid adherence to that stainless steel. So they get it, like you can see, it's like kinda cloudy looking. It's not a solid. If I'm doing anything with white then, I'm gonna give it a good white base before we start to work on it. So I always base them with a white.
Francesca says hello everyone.
Unless I have a cup that needs a stainless steel base.
Wonderful evening.
I just dumped an entire bottle of glitter all over my workspace and the floor.
Caitlin Rose says love the Halloween decorations.
Thank you.
Tamika says, think you missed a question, but did you paint the cup white before the glitter? I think we got that. Let's see here.
I haven't seen your ombre tumbler, but I will go check it out afterwards.
Caitlin Rose says,
tag me in your video. Go comment and tag me real quick so I don't forget to go look, because then I'll definitely see
it. Does your husband make anything? I usually make
dinner. Seahawks 7. Boop, boop. Halftime.
I usually make dinner. Somebody was asking if I make anything.
Oh, yeah. He makes dinner.
Leanna Design says, what brand are the cups, if you don't mind?
I use Hog and Tumblr Supply.
Depot. Tumblr Supply
Store. Tumblr Supply Store.
Ugh. Tasha Hill says,
I got a response from them on a code. I'm trying to get a discount code from them. Trying.
Jennifer H., did you see my ombre tumbler? You already answered that. Tamika, yep. Thank you. Aaron
All right,
Summer.
We got a glitter that we got to do for a glow-in-the-dark glitter. Going to dark glitter, coming up.
Nicola Dawn Blackmore says, going to sleep now. It's 2:50 a.m. in the morning.
Woo, girl, you get some rest. Thanks for hanging out with us for as long as you did.
If you scroll up, you'll see it. Anthony Z's wife.
Okay, you may have missed your message again, Mr. Turtle.
I What's thought I got them all. I keep having to scroll up.
It's going to be a fireworks tumbler, so our base is going to be glow glitters.
I've been, wait a minute, oh no, where did I hold it?
Uh-oh, did we miss it again?
I've been doing that and it's not doing anything. I see that one.
She can hit the question button and it'll come on there and then I'll definitely see it. Or you can message Mr. T directly after Koya visit. Hey, from Colorado, hey! Oh,
Anthony Z's wife, I'm still not seeing it. I went up quite a ways.
What made you start making cups? I've always done crafty stuff. And I saw a girl on Facebook making one live. And I was like, you know what? That looks pretty fun. So I want to try it. And so I ordered some supplies. And I had a lot of supplies already because I had a vinyl business that sold blanks. And so I ordered some supplies and I made my first tumbler and it turned out all right. Actually, we were going to the casino for the weekend because Mr. T used to do a lot of poker tournaments. And so when we'd be at the casino and he'd be playing for 12 hours, I'd be like, what the hell am I going to do? Well, you can only play slots for so long when you're there for 4 days. I went to Gatlinburg, I did the whole sightseeing. So after like the 8th trip, I'm just like, you know, I'm going to take my stuff and I'm going to make a tumbler. So I did. I took a Turner, epoxy, glitter, alcohol inks, and I made a tumbler, and it's sitting up on my shelf. It's my first Galaxy. It's pretty rough, but for my first tumbler ever, I was super proud of it. And then I experimented with fabric, and I didn't like that at all. And then I tried some others.
Posey the Name says, do you put last names on cups? My last name is 13 letters long. Think it will fit?
Sure, I can make it really small, too. Tiny, tiny, tiny. If I need to.
Anthony Z's wife says it won't allow me to message the page anymore. Miss Megan Rose says, what is your favorite glitter color you have?
Can you click on her, pull up her profile, send her a direct message from yours so she can reply. It'll open up that to hopefully she can reply. You're going to have to, yeah. All right, Mr. T's going to send you a message. You want to see it? You want to see what? Which one? All right, we got 177 people in here tonight. We're almost close to enough to do a giveaway. So keep sharing, keep tapping. We're a little low on taps tonight, guys. We're only at 66,000, and we're usually at 100,000 by now. So I need you guys to start tapping. If you're ready for a tap war, screenshot your total, because right now I think our highest tonight was what, 4,000? But if you are the winner, the highest for tonight, you're gonna be entering into a drawing for a free tumbler. So get ready to go on a tap war. On your marks, get set, go, tap! Tap, 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 keep tapping. Screenshot your
Kaylee
high score.
Denmark says, what
we're
time is
go
it
ahead
there?
And,
it is
we're
now
gonna glow glitter.
9:53 p.m.
We're gonna glow glitter.
These are really amazing pastels.
What is your favorite type of tumbler to make?
I like so many styles. They glow in the dark, and they glow really cool. They each glow in different colors. So we're gonna start the base of it with this on here, and then we're gonna be putting some decals down, some stencils down for a peekaboo. We're gonna paint it over black, and we're gonna remove those so those glow in the dark, and then we're gonna put some decals on the top that are glow in the dark vinyl. So you've got kind of a 3D effect going with the glow in the dark. So we're gonna do that here now. And this is just a scatter method. I don't want one section all pink. I want scattered. I want my fireworks to be different colors. So we're gonna do that. I'm gonna apply it with my clear gloss. So there's no epoxy on this tumbler. We're gonna use clear gloss as our adhesive. I did not paint the colors underneath, though it probably would be smart to do so. So I may do that. I may add a little bit of color. I think I might go with some lighter colors too. Okay. This is the good yellow. That might be the bad yellow. Purple.
Do you ever do rhinestones or just glitter?
I'm sorry?
Do you ever do rhinestones or just glitter?
I have done like rhinestone embellishments as like accent pieces, but not an entire rhinestone tumbler.
Caitlin Rose said the Galaxy. Kathy RM says, want to see your first tumbler.
You can grab it and show them when it's up on the shelf. It's rough. Rough. Man, I was so proud of that sucker. Let me tell you. All right, so I'm going to base the colors where I'm going to put that glitter. It's going to help with coverage. This is super pastel.
Anthony Z's wife said reply. Let me check real quick. Okay, it says that you were gonna check to see how much shipping was for what? Anthony Z's wife, shipping to where?
We ship international.
Caitlin Rose says, how do the people...
Most international places are about $25.
How the heck do people tap that long?
Right? I know.
So Kath says, any luck yet? No, not really.
No, I did find a couple cute ones, too, today.
Red Jeep Mama says, Jen, what did you think of the cup I shared earlier?
Not sure off the top of my head which one that is.
Look, Southern Woo Design says, hey, Turtle videos. Fam.
Hello, hello. I look at so many videos, so sometimes I forget to refresh my memory a little bit better.
Yeah, because it's, Rebecca, it's not on your page, so you must have sent it separately. Rajit Mama says she shared them to you on Facebook.
Oh, all right. I have to check. I can't. I'm on Facebook for like a hot second, and then I'm out. I'm not a Facebook on there very often. Literally jump in and out. So I'll check again.
Megan Gilly says, I adore that blue color. Oaks Pack says, I sent 2.1K likes.
Woo!
Couldn't screenshot fast enough. That's part of the game. Rose M S80 right, says, so how do you order a custom match. Cup?
You would normally go to my website and submit a or purchase there. But custom orders are closed for the moment.
Oh, the broken silhouette.
Oh, yeah.
We have to weigh that and see what it's going to cost.
I have no idea.
We'll get back to you on that, because now I'll remember.
Yeah. So I'm just throwing some glitter, the glow glitter, down over my spots.
Oh, so Kath's in Sedona, Arizona to surprise her son for his 40th.
Aw, that's so cool. That is so cool. When you're going to be back to the coast.
Dusty says to Megan that she knows that you like pink.
Yes.
Scrappy Girl says, I'm back. Megan Gilly says,
I don't mind pink.
No, hate on pink, just like the blue.
Yeah, I'm not a pink person either. I like it. I think it's pretty. But I don't have a lot of it.
Grizz Chick says, this would be an epic dump cup.
Right? It's glow, though. It's way too expensive to...
King, did Menopausal Mary Ween's tumbler go out? Menopausal Mary,
I don't know. Oh no, the Bloody Mary cup. Remember the winter cups we had?
Yeah. No, not yet.
Those are going out tomorrow, I think, right?
Yeah, Jen's waiting on special cards for those.
Yeah.
Cajun Angel says, "Hey." Bernie says, hey. "How do we know or see how many likes we have tapped? It'll pop up in your upper left-hand corner." Right where it says Thirsty Turtle, up in the upper left, when you start tapping, there's going to be a bar that's going to start filling up. And then once you stop, it's going to tell you how many taps you did. And that's when you need to take a screenshot. Dusty waves. Dusty's always sneaky in the background. Chris Chick said, my Jack and Sally shipped today. Yes, it did. Sean Overton. Hi, cool moderators from Sean Overton. You do an amazing job, guys.
They do. They are incredible. Get some more glow on this. These are going to be amazing fireworks that glow in the dark.
Bernie, are you on a computer or are you on your phone? Because if you're on a computer, I'm not sure you can tap. I think you have to be on a phone.
Yeah, I think you may have to be on a device.
A phone or a tablet or something like that.
Do we want to see the glow on this?
Well, then you should just be able to tap the screen. Tap right, like, in the middle of the screen, and you'll see little faces start to pop up.
All right, let's check the glow on this bad boy.
Jen, I love your shirt again. Way cool.
Thank you.
Way Nicole cool. Phillips Crafts says 1.5K likes.
Fantastic. I can't get over, like, 400 or 500. I think maybe 6-something was my high. I swear to God. I'm terrible. I'm a terrible tapper. Y'all keep inviting me into the lives and I try to tap and I'm a terrible tapper. Every little bit counts though.
200 viewers.
Hopefully get to that For You page. If you're here from the For You page, let's see some red hearts on the screen. You're here from the For You page. Because I don't think we're getting pushed to the For You page. Woohoo! Broke 200. That's like where I'm at. I get excited for little milestones. because I'm not a tapper. Sean got like 9,000 one time. I'm like, are you kidding me? I don't have that much attention span to get that far. I just don't. That's a crazy attention span. Mr. T stepped inside, so I'm going to come over here and watch comments. 2.4 thousand likes. Thank you. What? I'm so late. You're fine. 200 people. Not taps. Oh, we had 200 people in here. Fantastic. We're super close. We will. Really close. You got a hand or something in your hand cramped? That's kind of how I get. I'm like, ah! I'm not a good tapper. I'm not the person, if you need to go into a tap war and you need like a partner, I'm not the person to ask. I'm a pretty good cheerleader, but not a tapper. Mr. T, I'm going to put this glow glitter away. We're going to show him the glow on it because I'm probably going to have to do another coat depending on how well it glows. We hit 200 people in here, so we were really close to our number for the Michael Mod giveaway. What are your thoughts about that? Sharing the information.
Are you asking me?
Yeah.
I think that's up to you.
It got all dark in here. That's because we're going to show you some glow. You guys ready to see this glow glitter work? Hopefully we got some pretty decent savings because I got to do another coat. Hopefully we got some good coverage. But we'll find out. Oh, wow. Okay. All right, go ahead. So I know it looks all splotchy, right? Oh, the bottom I didn't charge. It looks splotchy. Go ahead. But they're going to have firework decal, like fireworks in those color sections. So that firework will glow pink and glow blue and glow yellow. It's going to get another coat, so it should kind of brighten up a little bit in that glow. All right, I'm gonna move these drying ones out of the way. All right, do I have more glitter cups? Do you have some decal cups? Let's do a decal here in a minute. And then I've got a blue ombre that I have to do. I got a blue ombre. You guys wanna do a blue ombre with me? And a specialized teacher cup I gotta get the rest of the glitter down on now that I figured out how the pattern's going. And I have a purple glitter cup to do that's gonna be a sunflower mama cup. And then I have a Harley Quinn. I have a Harley Quinn cup that we've got a spray paint and glitter. Kind of similar to the technique that we just did because that's actually going to be a collage type cup. And then I have, and I'm trying to think of what else. Oh, I have the decals to do for our blood clot awareness. And a couple other things. We're going to do our crayon tumbler. I'm gonna decal that here in just a second. Thank you. Go zero. What did he get? What happened? What did I miss? That's some serious glow. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's glow glitter too, so it's really cool. You have shoes on. I know I have shoes on. These are not shoes. These are my ass kicking boots. That's what I call them because they're biker boots. They're my ass kicking boots. All right, guys. Let's get this stuff ready to go. Mr. T, are you ready to step in?
Are you taking a break? Is that what you're doing?
Huh?
Oh, I didn't realize.
Yeah. Mr. T can show you some of the tumblers that we recently did. We did some power washes. We did some bandits. Show them your tumblers always. Alexa, next. Let's move that along.
The
crank up? What?
No, we don't want to show the crank up.
Not yet, because they have a decal to go on that. That he wants to see.
So what am I showing?
Green.
I just moved some over here. There's four over here.
Okay.
You gotta show this beauty again. God, I'm gonna have to cover that, and it's gonna make me sick. All right, I will be right back, guys. I'm gonna run to the restroom. I'm gonna go wash up a little bit, get some of this glitter off of me, because I spilled it everywhere. Do you see it?
Yeah, all over the place. Oh my God.
It's in my water. It's on my transfer tape. It's in all my little gadget drawers.
That's a bad spill. Yeah. Good job, Green.
It's beautiful, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I would give that a...
I mean, that is gorgeous, Claire.
A 9 out of 10.
You can show my...
The only way that could be better is if there was epoxy mixed to it so it sticks to everything. Yeah, I was planning on it. I was planning on it.
Awesome.
Hi, guys. Let's see here. Oh, Turtle, I love that. Mr. Turtle, I love that shirt. What?
Michael's Tumblr.
What about it? Are we doing that? Okay, yep, we can definitely do that. I love the shirt. Thank you, I made it.
No, you didn't.
I did not.
Sad Girl Designs made it. She's here on TikTok.
I like to take as much credit for everything as I possibly can because, well, it just makes me feel good about myself.
Because I do all the work.
Because Jen says she does all the work, so I got to take credit every once in a while. Okay, so let's see here. Before we go on, or move too far along here, I have a question for everybody, okay? I've been growing out my hair now for 4 years.
I thought this was going to get gross.
No, it's not a Tumblr question. I've been growing it out for 4 years. And as you can see, it curls up quite a bit. Now, if I pull it down and straighten it, you can see how long my hair is. But unfortunately, because it curls up, it looks like it's 3 inches shorter. So, what do I need to do to make it straight, other than blow drying it? Because that ain't gonna happen.
Because that just makes it frizzy and poof.
Because that just makes it frizzy and go poof.
Alexa Nix.
Curls don't grow quickly. Oh, my hair grows pretty quickly. It keeps curling upward instead of, like, I always thought flat iron it, straightener, get a straight perm. I'm not getting a perm. I always just thought that if it got long enough, the weight of it would just kind of pull it down. And it really doesn't. But anyway, what brand glitter do you use? Jen uses Black Bear Glitter, which is Glitter Dealer BBG here on TikTok. She also uses BJ's Glitter. And then an assortment of some other glitters as well. I love my flat iron brush. Okay, first of all, guys, let me explain something, okay? Until I started growing out my hair, which was 4 years ago, I did not use even a blow dryer until I was 50 years old, okay? And I'm 51 now. So if you're asking me to use tools to do something to my hair, that's probably not going to happen. Mr. T, try what... Try Curly Girl Method on YouTube. Curly Girl Method.
She's a user.
Marine Corps cut. Until 5 years ago, I wore my hair 0 to 3 on the sides, and on the top it was about that long, and I would spike it up. So I just started growing it out when Baby Turtle went off to college. Flat iron brush, use it on dry hair. Really? If I use a flat iron anything, I'm gonna burn my hair off.
We tried that. It works, but...
Alright, so anyway, tumblers while Jen's taking a break. Somebody asked earlier to see Jen's first tumbler. This was the first tumbler she ever created. It was a Galaxy tumbler, and needless to say, she's a little embarrassed about it, but we do keep it for posterity purposes, so it's always up on the top of the shelf. So this was the first one that she made, and then she started making these types of tumblers, which were, this is a 5-panel tumbler for her favorite movie, Wizard of Oz, and this one turned out pretty good, but at the time, she wasn't using UV epoxy, so a lot of it yellowed out. Because when she created this 3 years ago, they really didn't have UV epoxy. So those were the first two tumblers that she made. And of course, with tumbler making, just like with any other skill, the more you do it, the more you perfect it. So some of the tumblers that she's just completed out, we had to recreate the Ohano from the ready-to-ship sale because we did have some people that all clicked at the same time. So instead of us only selling the stock that we had some customers that ended up over-ordering and we had to recreate. So this is going to be going out shortly and finishing up all of the, Halloween ready-to-ship. Somebody also asked, do I make cups? This is one of the cups that I'm working on right now. And you can see me work on this again on Mondays at 8:30 on Men Who Craft Mondays. I usually have another male crafter or another crafter on with me so that we can dual live and create at the same time. And here's some of the other tumblers that I've made and still haven't finished. So apparently I have the ability to create tumblers, but not finish them. So this one needs another coat of epoxy. It needs to be rimmed, but this is a Southwestern I did. I had to use thicker pinstriping because, well, this was really the first glitter tumbler I had ever done in my life. I made Jenna Cleveland Brown's one because we are from Ohio, so Block O, the Ohio State, and then the Cleveland Browns tumbler for football season. This was an alcohol ink one I did with neon alcohol inks. And it's really pretty, almost too pretty, so I had to man it up and put Deadpool on it, even though he's riding on his unicorn. Woo! And then this one is a reptile skin that you create with epoxy, and then you put a silicone mat out over it that has the pattern on it, and you we rubber band it down real tight so that the epoxy fills into those areas. And then Jen just spray painted it black, and I put mica powders over the top of it to give it that kind of metallic-y look. So yes, I do make tumblers every once in a while. I used to do all of Jen's epoxying because she was having horrible reactions to the epoxy she was using. Last October, she broke out in October, and it didn't actually go away until almost March, April. And in that process, she started trying a bunch of different epoxies. O-H-I-O! She started using a bunch of different epoxies. And she found some that work very well that don't make her break out. We believe what was causing the breakout was the amount of UV protection that was in the epoxy. Because until we started working with UV epoxy, she didn't have very seldom any breakouts whatsoever. But the thing with epoxy is everybody is kind of allergic to it, and eventually it's going to catch up with you. Let's see. I broke out with epoxy, not sure how to avoid it. You just got to try a bunch of different ones. The one that she's had the best success with
is allergic by touch, though.
Yeah, she's allergic by touch, so it depends on what you're allergic by. If she gets it on her, she'll break out in hives in within an hour. But she uses mainly, what is it, Liquidy Split? Liquidy Split from KS Resin. And she's had the best success with that. She doesn't get many breakouts from that at all. But it does have a little bit more of an odor to it. It almost smells like chlorine from a pool. But it's not massively overpowering, so it does work. All we can say is just try it and see what happens. Mr. T, I emailed you my screenshot. How do I email you my screenshot? You can send it to Jen@ThirstyTurtleTumblers.com. Jen@ThirstyTurtleTumblers.com. And then we'll be able to see that. Praise God, I've had no reactions. That's great that you've not had any reactions. I ordered the K resin and I don't really break out anymore. See?
Yeah.
Oh, Sheriff Owl Ruta. We were just talking about you today.
Because we had a Sherry Fowler pull into the neighborhood.
Yeah, we had a Sherry Fowler pull into the neighborhood and we go, ooh, Sheriff Owl Ruta. So strange because I'm the opposite. I am very allergic to KS resin. Like I said, it's you got to try them. They're, every one of them uses a different formula, and they put in.
There's so many different chemicals.
And there's so many different ones that it could just be. You just need to try some additional ones. How much for the reptile one that I made? I don't know. What are you doing? Most of my tumblers kind of either get sold on an RTS sale, or we were thinking of doing all of the tumblers that are made on Men Who Craft Monday, putting them up for auction and giving away that money to a good cause. So we don't know what we're going to do with that yet. The carnage from the dump cup. Oh, it's bad. Sheriff Al Ruta is laughing. Let's see. A little extra ink epoxy is partially plant-based. Only one I haven't had a reaction to. Ink epoxy, INC epoxy, it's plant-based. What's the set time on it? Because that's always a massive component to the epoxies that we try. Like Jen tried KS resin. Crystallac. Crystallac doesn't work for us. We just have too many orders, and to put that many coats on it, it just doesn't work for our business. I had a reaction all the time before switching to KS. Love how far the epoxy has come in 3 years. I know, right? 3 years ago, there was art epoxy, and that was pretty much it. And it was going to yellow, and it was an 8-hour cure time. An 8-hour hardening time. Cure time was like 72 hours before you could even touch it. So, yeah, I mean, the epoxy is just, it's huge jumps over the last couple years. Sorry, was typing too fast. Amber, bye-bye. Email again, Mr. T, jen@thirstyturtletumblers.com. jen@thirstyturtletumblers.com. I'll take Deadpool right now, sold. Michael.
Right?
It's going to be cool once I get the epoxy on it. Is it called a little extra ink, a.k.a. ale?
A little extra. No, I've tried a little extra.
It sets up for me in about 5 hours. Yeah, we need something a little faster than that with the amount of tumblers that we do. We're a 2-hour epoxy family. The KS resin liquidy split, within 2 hours it's dry to touch, and we can take them off the turner and not have to worry about them, you know, settling weird. Okay, it said you mentioned me. Kristen Lynn, I don't know if it said we mentioned you. It said, is this cup yours?
Oh, see?
I think that's what it said. And it could be your cup if you've ordered one from us. I will take the purple reptile. I will send Jen an email. It's not available yet. It'll probably go up for either our next ready-to-ship sale. Yes, thank you for, you know, wanting to purchase the tumblers I made. but it'll either go up on an RTS sale or it'll go up for an auction. So it's going to be a little bit yet. And I've been working on those tumblers now for like 8 weeks and they're still not done. So you can order it, but you might not receive it until like 2025. Yeah, my turnaround time is 4 years. Okay, you almost ready, Green?
Almost.
All right. Jen's going to come back because she's going to be working on the Crayola Crayons tumbler. And then she's got a bunch of other ones. Oh, the one I didn't show you. Jen's really struggling with this one right here. If you guys remember, she epoxied this, I think, on Monday's live.
We spray painted it and then glittered it and then we epoxied.
And she's having a real hard time with the next step for this tumbler.
I don't want to cover it.
Because it's a Milky Way, which means she's going to be covering it with white epoxied paint. And she doesn't want to cover it up because it is gorgeous. Especially, look at that blue sparkling. Ugh.
So stinking pretty. I'm almost thinking about making another one to do the Milky Way on.
Right? They're saying it's gorgeous as is. And that's the problem that she's having. She does not want...
I tried twice today to do it, and I just can't. I can't get myself to do it.
She just does not want to put anything on it. So, all right. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Jen's coming back, guys. Thanks for allowing me to take up some of your time.
Appreciate
but, you know, you're here for her.
Did you love my first tumblers?
I didn't see the comments on the tumblers.
Weren't those amazing, guys? We're going to be doing a alcohol ink blue method because I have a rainbow that I have to dig. I have to do. So, whoa, I'm going to need that for sure. I got to get my, arm. Yeah. It's drying, so we got a minute before this finish dries.
I never did tell them what they need to do to get it.
Oh, do you want to tell them real quick while I'm finishing this epoxy mix?
Okay. Lahanu and Zero, you're still here, right?
Lahanu, are you still here, Zero? You love my first tumblers? I was so proud of them. I showed them off. I've come a long way. Your email bounce back, Jen at thirstyturtletumblers.com.
With an S.
Plural, S tumblers.
Okay, Zero's here. Okay, guys, so.
It is really beautiful. I might just make another one.
Depending on what happens tonight, we might do the drawing tonight, but more than likely it's going
to
happen on Saturday.
Stick to fail.
Okay.
What? Zero's here. Yep, they're here. Go ahead.
So what you need to do to get entered into the drawing for either a 20-ounce custom of your choice, which Michael Scales is giving away. He's one of our moderators. He won it during our RTS sale for having the most people tied for having the most people use his code for free shipping. So he's giving away his tumbler because he's a great guy, and he has like 20 of our tumblers already.
Like, I don't need another Thirsty Turtle.
So he's going to be giving that away. So we'll either be giving that away or we might be giving away both. We might be giving away the Michael Scales one plus the pumpkin one that Jen started tonight. But both of those are probably going to happen on Saturday.
Well, we also have the new, where'd it go? The black flame candle we're going to give away.
Oh, so there could be three that could be given away on Saturday depending on how many people join our live.
Tonight, we hit 200 tonight, so we're going to start the giveaway already. We're going to start the giveaway for Michael's tumbler.
So, what you need to do is you need to follow Lahanu. And the reason we want you to do this is because her son, Zero, is an 8-year-old crafter. And we want to get him up to 1,000 followers so that he can join me on a Men Who Craft Monday and we can do a dual live while he's working on some of his crafts.
He's kind of the honorary member of the reason why we started Men Who Craft Monday.
Okay, so he was getting bullied by some kids at school because he likes to craft. Our thought process was,
that's cool.
Let's show that men, do craft as well.
Well, just all sorts of people can craft.
And when we say craft,
men,
it's not...
It's like anything artsy, crafty.
But because he's a little boy, they didn't think... They made fun of him because he likes to craft. Okay? So we're trying to show there's no reason for that. And so to get him...
He makes some really amazing things.
So to get him up to 1,000 followers, what we need you guys to do is follow Lahanu. She's probably already messaged a couple times in here, so you can see who she is. Follow them.
We love Zero.
Comment on one of their videos and tag me at Mr. Thirsty Turtle.
Signs over here if you want to grab it.
That's how you get entered into the drawing. Okay? I think they have like
350 followers so far. So we need to get them up to 1,000.
All right, your sign's right over here. No, that's
thirstytrolltumblr.com. Oh, that's the
wrong one. Tag at Mr. Thirsty Turtle.
In the comment.
Okay. And that's how you're gonna get entered in to win one of the Michael's tumbler that he's giving away as a mod. Torching it out a little bit just so I can get those finger lines from spreading the epoxy. Kind of have them blend out, disappear. Popping any micro bubbles, because I'm not going to be able to torch this after I put these alcohol inks on it, because it's going to alcohol and flame. If you do it in a controlled, planned environment, it'd probably be pretty badass. But, all right, we're going to go ahead and alcohol ink this. I'm going to drop colors on this. You're not going to see them until I hit them with the white. So, you got to have a little bit of patience for me. Okay? Going to be a bloom method, so as soon as it gets hit with the white, all of a sudden those colors are going to start to show up.
They're
going to bloom. Alexa, next. I know. So I said you should be over there dominating poker night.
I have a job.
You have a job. I have a job. Sorry, guys. Mr. T is taking a minute, and then he'll be back to reading comments. I was losing my yellow, so I'm going to give myself a little bit more room for yellow. My yellow seems to disappear.
So worst case scenario, by following Lahanu, you're just getting a head start on the drawings that may happen on Saturday.
It'd be awesome. Yeah, that's three cups, Mr. T. We gotta start getting rid of these cups.
We got a lot of people in for those three cups.
I know.
Oh my God, wait till you guys see the drink we're making on Saturday.
Whoop, whoop! We'll be posting the recipe soon. We didn't like the original recipe. Thank God Kryptonian built, tested that sucker out. He said it was terrible. So he switched up the recipe on us. This one looks really good. I don't know if he's tried it yet, but it looks good. It's a milkshake. So, I mean, come on. Who doesn't like milkshakes?
With a little bit of alcohol in it.
A little bit of alcohol in it. Adult time.
There might be pumpkin flavored to go along with the cup that Jen's making.
It's probably pumpkin flavored. Which would explain why we're making pumpkin cups. Alrighty, we're about ready. The last color's going on. You guys ready to see this? I'm gonna hit the bottom. I always forget the bottom.
Oh my God, the video's gonna be up in a few, Daza says.
Sweet!
Sean Overton, I'm behind him. Okay, thank you. I'm not sure what that was.
Can't wait!
Zero Skill Art says, LOL.
I'm all right, y'all ready?
I'm the lesser zero.
Go. Here we go.
Daza said, I was told to stop drinking it. I've already had two.
Oh, it's that good, huh? All right. Swatch. The colors are going to start blooming out.
Anthony Z's wife says, keep tapping and sharing.
Ashley Anderson says,
what's the white you use to do that?
It's Pinata White Alcohol Ink. The Blanco.
Francesca
Blanco
says, make a new rainbow and let me buy that one. I need a rainbow.
I'm Zero sure says, that can happen.
Jen, I'm working on a
octopus painting. Moving around? Oh, cool.
I think that's what it is. I'm not sure what the emoji is. I'm not good with emojis, Zero. I'm old. Francesca said the glitter one. Like that one.
Oh,
over
I
there.
Gotcha. Yeah, that thing is.
Carrie White Lafferty, thank you for those gifts. That'll get you entered into our October gifter drawing.
We're going to touch up our colors, right?
Rory Collier, same thing.
Make them pop.
Daza said, yes, it's very good.
Excellent.
Oaks Pack says, oh my God, that's amazing and hypnotic. Tanya Nepp, where do you get the alcohol ink from?
These are Marabu inks. I usually use Black Bear Glitters inks, but these I like for this particular method. And that's what these are. These are the Marabus. So I can show you those here in just a second. Most of your glitter suppliers carry them.
I wish somebody would teach me how to Dougie. Y'all need to see my Instagram. I do jewelry and digital art.
Oh,
zero skill art. We have some sub boxes that are coming up, and we are still looking for some crafters to help to donate some items for those sub boxes.
Your marketing materials on that.
Yep.
Put your name
you throw
out
in
there.
Your business card, staple them to your products.
We're gonna be releasing
we'll
the
put
Halloween
you on
videos,
the
yeah.
The website as soon as I can get it updated, so that people can see what you're producing, and they're gonna get some marketing materials from you and show what kind of, you know, what you do. It's a great way for to get some additional marketing, to get some additional followers if you're a crafter and trying to break out.
Yep. So if you're interested, we got some boxes coming up soon.
Bella Aussie Dog says, Turtle Love, hi.
Hello.
Sheriff.
I forgot my weight on the bottom.
Sheriff Al Rutaw says, that's beautiful.
Forgot the weight on the bottom.
Serena says, love that cup. Cynthia S39 says,
Hoxie's
love it.
Out.
Bella Aussie Dog, how many boxes do you do?
Usually it's about 20. That gives us enough to cover the boxes.
Padded Big Chick says, waiting on my business cards.
Excellent. So if you can, I try not to make it too many because I don't want you to have to overcommit to that. I know it's a lot of materials. So if you can do the 20, that's awesome. If you can do 10, I can do that for the other boxes.
Zero Skill Art says, if you were talking to me, my signal dropped out. I didn't hear. Of course you didn't. I was giving you my sales pitch. It took like 10 minutes. No, Zero Skill Art, what we do is we have sub boxes that go out pretty much every other month. We have our October boxes that'll be going out tomorrow or Saturday. I think they're going out Saturday, which are our Halloween gnome boxes. Then we have our pinup princess box, which is the fall one that will be going out immediately following. And generally, we don't just send a tumbler. We also send some additional items, which are created by other crafters here on TikTok who donated those items to our sub box. So it's a way of getting some additional marketing if you're trying to break out to get some recognition for the craft and the arts that you do.
Yep, and we do, I think I might grab some of those.
Lacey J, the Border Collie, says, hello, Turtles. Zero says, love it. Bernie says, I give up on variations of email to be accepted. Francesca says, great work, Jen.
Yeah, this is super pretty.
Amber Beby says, this song. Lonnie Nixon said, 6.5K likes.
Woo!
Barbie's Creation says, looks great.
We're at
183,000
likes. All right, let's see if we can hit 200,000. We've done it a few times before. Got some spots in my epoxy.
Zero Skill Art signal just came back.
I had to bring out my red from Black Bears to get that saturation color in there. I wanted it to be a much brighter red.
Mama of a Beautiful Wild Child says that's absolutely beautiful.
Look at these spots. These
Corey says this is so gorgeous. Becca Ford says, hi, I would love that tumbler. Where do I get one?
Look at the bottom. It's beautiful.
Lonnie Nixon, thank you for those gifts. That'll get you entered into our October drawing for our gifters.
Thank you very much.
For the opportunity to win a free 20-ounce custom tumbler of your choice.
Yup, yup. All right, we're going to let this one spin. I got a sweet.
Daza
says, keep moving the direction, though.
Daza says, don't slam the drink. I repeat, do
don't
not slam,
slam
the drink.
Okay.
Koya said, that's BBG cool. Inks to the rescue.
Right? Yeah, I needed that brighter red color in there because it just wasn't getting my turn them more pinkish.
Christine Kibler says, can I ask a dumb question? Do you spray anything on glitter before epoxy?
I do. I seal my glitter with clear gloss, usually. And I pretty much do it on everyone. Because I don't want it to move around, and I don't want a bunch to fall off while I'm glittering, and I don't want it to fall on other cups or anything like that. So I usually seal it a couple times, and then once it's done drying from the sealer, I take a really soft, super soft paintbrush and brush off any loose glitter, then I epoxy. Can't believe that was the entire cup of glitter. I do need one of those tilt turners. I have it in my cart. If y'all are in the market for turners, MH Turners is what I use. I've been using them for almost a year. I bought their 12 cup and 2 single cups. And those suckers have been cranking nonstop for about 10 months. And they're amazing. So you can use T321 as a code if you are in the market for purchasing a MH Turner. T321. I know, that glitter, it's upsetting me. I'm like, oh my God, I can't believe I did that. All right, let's get these decals on this crayon cup. I don't have to think about that glitter spillage. And this will give me a chance to read some comments too. A comment for the giveaway. So you wanna go to Lahanu, she's on here, Lahanu. If you grab her, go follow her and comment on there. She just commented, comment on one of her videos and tag Mr. Thirsty Turtle. If you do that, that's going to get you entered in to win the cup from our Michael Mod giveaway.
Michael, you have your own thing now. It's called the Michael Mod giveaway.
The Michael Mod giveaway. And then we have the Black Flame cup. Where the hell is that cup at? Seriously, where'd the Black Flame cup go? It's drying somewhere. What the hell is it?
I don't know, but the cat just took over my seat.
Uh-oh. Where's the Black Flame cup?
Black Flame cup.
There it is. It's right in front of my face. We're going to finish this one up. It glows purple. It's pretty cool. It glows purple. See how it's bright and glow. So we're going to finish that one up. That's going to be one of our giveaway cups. And then we're going to have a pumpkin cup or two to give away. There's my chunky monkey. My big fat
sugar monkey. He's not fat at all. He's just big bone.
Cool. Thank you for that gift. That was the music notes. That was way cool. That was Angel Axon. Is that who that is? Oh, that purple cup is so awesome. Has Beetlejuice shipped yet? Those are... I got to put a coat of epoxy on it. I fixed the drip. I had to do another coat.
She broke the drip twice. Well, actually, I broke it once. She broke it once.
I broke it once because I knocked it over and it rolled.
Amber Beebe, thank you for those gifts, hon. He's pleasantly plump.
The cloud
bread. Yes, he is.
He's a plump guy, yeah. He is.
He's like 18 pounds. And no cat should weigh 18 pounds unless it's like a bobcat or, you know, one of those types of cats.
Yeah, he's a beefy cat. He actually really doesn't eat all that much either, to be honest.
Sweet mom says, I have two twins that look like your chunky monkey. Ours are R2 and D2. Oh my God, love you a ton. That is awesome.
Kevin Clark sent roses. Thank you, Kevin.
Kevin Clark.
You're trying to win that tumbler, aren't you? I got you, dude. You're entered.
Mr. T, go to your corner. Why?
Uh-oh, what did I do? Oh, for messing up her glitter.
What did I do, Daza? Angie?
Her drip.
Man, what did I do?
Oh, Daza said it. Oh, shit.
We have a BB-8, too. You're in trouble. Oh, my God. You guys are awesome. I'm going to have to check out you guys. Hopefully, if you guys are that big of Star Wars, you guys Amy, you need to start putting some videos on your TikTok page. Because you got my interest just by the name of your pets.
Just for the pet name. We just want to see videos of your dogs. Of your pets. There's Lahanu, guys. Tag Lahanu. Go follow her. You're going to get entered in to win for that tumbler.
Spark up your life. I didn't get an email for the Cheshire Cat Cup. Hoping it comes to the right place. It's sitting right there in the pile.
Is your address that you provided not Has it changed? If it has changed, send me a new email. I will make sure Mr. T checks those before he chips them out.
Seahawks are losing. I'm over this season.
What? Wait, they were winning. Now they're losing? Damn it.
Sean Overton said, what a cute cat, Jen and Mr. Turtle. Gaza said the drips. Oh, I had to go to my corner because I broke the drips.
They broke the drips. I know. Yeah, the cat's funny because he...
They're down 16-7.
Oh, shit. He showed up. And when we were trying to... When we took him to get him checked to see if he was chipped, we found out his real name because we didn't know it. And we found out it was Braxton. And Braxton, at the time that he showed up here, Braxton Miller was the quarterback for Ohio. No, yeah, quarterback for Ohio State. And we're like, well, he's ours now. Like, it was meant to be. We follow our Buckeyes. So that's why I watch some of the different NFL teams, because they have our Buckeyes on them. I'm on DDN Saturday.
Rams 16, Hawks 7. Oof. Rams are tough. The Rams are going to be tough this year. Really tough.
That's Rams. That's what's his name? Who went to the Rams?
The quarterback from Detroit went to the Rams. But if you're looking for a Buckeye, I don't.
Yeah.
I don't know of any Buckeyes that are at the Rams.
Bosa went to.
Russell Wilson got hurt. He'll be playing shortly because you can't keep that guy down. The Corey says, yes, go Buckeyes. Dogboy Brewery says, 12 minutes left in the game. What do you use to get the vinyl and glitter and rhinestones to stick?
They all have different things. So glitters, you can use adhesives.
Yeah, like, Matthew Stafford went to the Rams.
Like Mod Podge or glitter glue or clear gloss spray paint or epoxy to adhere for glitter. For what was the other thing?
Francesca wants to know if you have a P.O. box if someone wanted to send you gifts.
I don't have a P.O. box right now. It's just our address.
But yeah.
But we're going to be moving, and I don't know when that is going to happen. So.
But if you've received a cup from us anything. Or an order from us, it is on our shipping labels. But if you need it, you can email us, and we will definitely send it to you.
All right, we're going to do this at the top. So we need to eyeball how far apart. It's about an inch. Get our little crayons on here.
Zero Skill Art says, I almost ran over a possum.
Oh no!
Touchdown Seahawks, see?
Woo-hoo!
You guys aren't that far out of it.
The only reason why I root for the Seahawks is because I like their team colors. They're my favorite jersey colors. I mean, come on, 14. Blue and like lime green. That's freaking awesome.
Have my comments been coming through, Grizz Chick? I saw that one. If there were any ones earlier and I didn't catch them, then they might have been blocked. Or I just missed them. It's possible it's either or.
Both can happen for sure.
Oaks Pack says stolen home base for Tampa Bay Rays.
What?
They stole home? That doesn't happen very often.
Yeah. Somebody screwed up.
Chris Chick said, then you should be a Sounders fan. Who's the Sounders? Serendipity Sounders. By Mandy says, I'm a Saints fan. Yeah, I said it.
We are too. We love New Orleans.
But
so.
I love the Bengals helmets.
Their helmets were pretty badass too. Yeah. I mean, the Cleveland Browns, seriously. Orange and brown. Who said, yeah, that's a good color combination?
That was before they had color TV.
That's true. At least the Panthers are like black and
the Seattle teal. Sounders soccer.
Gotcha. Yeah, I don't watch a lot.
Bear
I
the Bengals girls, says the Bengals are cool.
Team, but I don't watch men's
soccer. Serendipity by Mandy says I'm from Louisiana, but now live in Atlanta. I bet you want to move back to Louisiana, don't you? Because we lived in Atlanta,
that
too.
That traffic is something.
And you're going to lose a third of your life sitting in traffic.
Yeah, you're going to be planning your day around that traffic. I loved Atlanta until I drove in it. Y'all do 70 miles an hour on the highway, bumper to bumper, in rush hour.
Boop
you
koozie.
Don't even slow down. You just bumper to bumper it at 70 miles an hour during rush hour.
Boo koozie, ghost fan here. Serendipity says, nope, so you like Atlanta better?
Ugh.
Francesca says, what is a brown? That's what I want to know. What are browns?
It's just a color. Poop.
There he is, Ryan. What's up, everyone? Drink. TikTok is up.
Woo-hoo!
All right, so what you guys just saw there was Kryptonian Bill. He's one of our moderators. He's also our resident mixologist. He tests
resident,
all of our
like
drinks.
Like he lives with us. He doesn't. He's just in our turtle family.
He tests all of our drinks before we make them on our Saturday Live. Because on our Saturday Lives, we start off with making an alcoholic beverage.
Mr. T is a terrible bartender.
I am a horrible bartender, so I need all the help I can get. And Ryan has graciously provided me with the assistance.
Sorry, this is boring. This cup, I'm sorry.
He has
it's
sent us a blend jet. He sent us pourers.
I know, we're going to use the blend jet again, which is nice.
Edible glitter for drinks. I mean, he is
incredible.
Amazing. So if you're not following him, give him a follow because him and Daza make amazing videos for the drinks that we do on Saturdays.
They're so fun to watch. You definitely want to follow so you can get the recipe. Because I keep forgetting to post the
just
recipe.
Because says that's why you just open a beer. Yeah, but you can only do that so many times. Okay, so here's the beer we're drinking tonight, guys.
I don't like the taste of beer at all.
No.
I don't
Jen's
like
favorite
smell
beer.
Of it either.
Jen's favorite beer is Blue Moon, and she has
with
to put
an entire
she
orange.
Has to put like 12 orange slices in it.
Not exaggerating. Like seriously. On a super hot day. Not a beer drinker.
Yep, Amber B by Browns are the only team in the NFL that doesn't have a logo on their helmets. Dog Boy Brewery, I can make
because it's brown and orange. What are you going to put on
true.
That?
That's true. Dog Boy Brewery could probably make you exactly what you would want in a beer. So if you
probably.
Told him what flavors you're looking for.
So I do like the, remember that beer that we had that was the...
The Grapefruit Shanty.
The Grapefruit Shanty. But what was that one that we tried that was the cherry dark?
Oh,
it was a really like a Guinness
yeah.
almost, but it was cherry
Creek.
Flavored.
It's called a Creek beer.
Creek
and
beer.
It has a ton of cherry. It's almost like a cherry brandy mix. And she really liked that.
That was really good. That was really good. So basically, I like beer that doesn't taste like beer.
Yeah, that's basically what she's looking for is a beer that doesn't taste like a beer. Cherry Jubilee Stout. Ooh, that sounds amazing.
That's what it sounds like. That cherry one. Sounds like it was a Jubilee Stout or something like that. Because it was dark. But
it was
really
thicker.
Like red, thick beer.
Yeah, it was
but
a thicker
was...
beer. So it probably was a stout.
God, it was so good.
A. Tomlinson says, I want to like beer because it's cheaper to drink, but I'm 30 and it just isn't happening now.
You know why I don't like beer? I don't like the smell of it mostly. I don't like the smell of it.
Or the aftertaste.
Or the, I don't even like the smell of it, like, afterwards. Like, that beer, I just don't like that beer, like, beer that's spilled.
Carrie White Lafferty, you definitely can. Send us any recipe that you want. But generally, the recipes that we do is something that Jen can make a tumbler with. So keep that in mind.
Yeah.
Because
usually I have to pick what kind of tumbler we want to make.
And then we find a drink to match the tumbler.
And I use this for kind of the fun, crazy ones that I haven't done, but I want to do because I don't have any. I've only got like
oh my God. Susan 1955 says, I like Little Kings. Little
Whoa.
Kings was the first beer I ever got drunk on.
Whoosh.
I think I was 13 years old.
It was the first beer I threw up on because.
And they were so cool because they were like
a cigar too.
The little 8-ounce bottles or whatever, like the little 8-ounce green bottles. But oh my God, yeah. My favorite beer is Modelo. I love Modelo. I've always been a Mexican beer drinker. Dos Equis, Modelo.
Corona, originally.
Originally, I started on Corona and then realized how bad Corona is compared to some of the other Mexican beers.
Yingling is a Mexican, that's German.
Yeah, we've been to quite a few different... We have
we went with our daughter for her 25th
Raleigh
birthday.
Raleigh Beer Garden.
Beer and bacon fest.
Right, but I'm talking about the Raleigh Beer...
We've got a Charlotte Beer Garden.
So yeah, now we have a Charlotte Beer Garden. It's beautiful. And the thing is so amazing. The plants that they have in there, the vines, everything. It's an indoor-outdoor type of place. And they probably have, no kidding, 400 different beers on tap. They'll have a whole wall filled with cider-type beers, a whole wall filled with stout. I mean, it's just, it's amazing.
Alexa,
you can go there and spend hours and hours, probably weeks, trying all the different types of beers that they have.
Does y'all's local radio stations play nothing but Olivia Rodriguez and Ariana Grande? Because I love both of them, but I'm so tired of hearing them. It's always on the radio. Sorry, I had to get that out.
Oh my God, they have Little Kings now in lime and orange? Seriously? I haven't seen Little Kings since I was in high school.
Minus the cigar and I'm good. Just kidding.
Serendipity by Mandy says, Millet Ponies ice cold on a summer day. What is Millet Ponies?
Millet Ponies a beer?
A craft beer? Big Al, 19773. Thank you for those gifts. That'll get you entered into our monthly gifter drawing to win a free 20-ounce custom tumbler of your choice.
Those roses were very nice of you.
Amber Beebye, why was I trying to read the cup backwards?
I don't know.
Because Jen doesn't know how to flip the camera?
Because I know. Well, my brain doesn't work when I flip the camera. So, you give me just a second. I'll show it to you. I'm trying to line these up and get them centered.
Miller Ponies. So, not Little Kings. Miller Ponies. I've never seen Miller Ponies. The music manager says, loving that cran tumbler.
It's so cute.
Tracy McHenry,
loving
the cup.
One more to do, and then I'll show you.
Oaks Pack says, this cup is so darling. Dogboy Brewery, what about Blood Orange IPA? Jen likes Blood Orange.
I like Blood Orange. So
IPAs are too
not
hoppy.
Not my favorite.
Not, yeah, we're not an IPA. No, IPAs are bad.
But I do like Blood Orange.
Grizz Chick, I'll check it as soon as we get off this live, hon. Julia Jones says, oh my God, and Doja Cat. Zero Skill Art, the email, I will post it here in the message real quick.
I'm going to need that.
Valerie Y from TikTok doesn't mean I want to listen to it on the radio.
Yeah, right? It's like, but they just play it constantly.
Grizz Chick says, y'all got to come to Montana and do the Brie Trail.
The Brie Trail. What is that?
If it didn't snow in Montana, I would love to come to Montana.
Well, we just have to go when it doesn't snow year-round there, right?
9 months out of the year.
Does it really?
It's cold in Montana.
Are you crazy? No, I know there's people that really love the snow. I am not one of them. I am
Furby's
the opposite.
Says hard apple cider for me or a liquid cinnamon roll.
Hard apple cider's pretty good.
Vanessa Horton, what kind of paper?
Okay, I'm going to flip the camera.
What
My
kind
brain's
of paper
gonna
is
shut
that?
Off. What kind of what?
Paper is that?
This paper is wax paper.
Lorraine B, I like Yingling. I like Yingling,
these are
too.
Dry, Interfold dry wax papers. This is vinyl on here. I'm going to turn the camera. Aww. My brain's going to shut off because I don't function when it's flipped like that. I seriously can't function. So I may be able to keep talking. I'm not sure. But I'll show it to you so you can read it.
Big Al said, my mom told me about y'all. She watches you every day.
See, I did it wrong again. Okay, don't look at the camera, Jen. Nope, wrong way. Nope, wrong way. Nope, tip it. Nope, tip it this way. There we go. Tip it. Nope. Don't look at the camera. I'm getting it. I'm getting
it. You're doing good. Just stay right there.
Don't look at the
You're
camera.
Good.
Don't look at the camera. Okay. I did it. Whew.
Amber Beby says, I moved to North Carolina, then moved back, missing the snow.
Mm-mm, no thanks. Snow somewhere you go to visit. Somewhere where you go visit snow, then you come home to sun. That's so stinking cute. I hope our customer loves that. Whose is this? Oh, it's Kesha's.
Keisha Brown Eyes?
Gordine, yeah.
Yep, Keisha Brown Eyes. Keisha. Chris, with all the antics, says, I want to move to Montana so badly. I don't know why, but woke up one day and said, I need to live there.
The drip cup we did the other day is dried. I've got to clean up the bottom. But it looks pretty
sweet
cool.
Sweet mom says, someone misses snow. Weird.
Yeah, that's just insane.
Mr. and Mrs. T, what's our favorite colors?
Purple. Black and purple for me. Probably, what's for you, Mr. T? I know you like Buckeye colors, but...
I like any blues, any greens, because now generally I'm talking about clothes because they make my eyes pop.
Because it's eye color.
So I've always kind of driven my colors towards
eyes, can,
those
whatever.
Things. But I really like purple and I like black. I like scarlet and gray.
We do coat two on our glow glitters.
Butterfly kisses for Anna, says hello, hello. Christina Barghisi says, I like that a lot. Sean Overton says, really cool, Jen. Oakspack says, from Utah and hate snow and cold. Serendipity by Mandy, green is my favorite color and the color of my eyes.
See? Brown is not my favorite color. But it is the color of my eyes.
Randa said, send me your favorite colors you like the most. Do you like the best, please?
Yeah, mine's purple and black and then teal.
Zero says mommy loves this song. Grizz Chick, you are 95% safe. June 15th, it's iffy, sometimes late September. Usually have snow by Halloween.
What?
In Montana.
Now, here's
from Montana.
So
too.
I'm not going to lie. We grew up in Ohio, and when I was a kid, when you went and got your Halloween costumes, you had to get it a size bigger because you had to put a snowsuit underneath it.
Lorraine B says
because it either snowed before Halloween or it was freaking cold to go trick-or-treating. And so when we moved south, my kids actually got to wear the cute costumes because in Georgia, it's like 80 degrees while you're trick-or-treating. So it's like, but I feel bad for the northern kids trick-or-treating. I'm sorry.
Let me see here. Where was I? Lorraine B says, I think I've found my favorite Tumblr talk.
Aww.
Zero Skill Art says, okay, y'all, back to driving. Be safe, Zero.
Be safe.
Grizz Chick said, I went in the snowsuit.
Yep, snowsuit.
Tanya Knapp says, okay. Jen, me too. We love the same colors.
Yep.
Ryan says, I like the green. I like the way the green tastes. Ryan, what are you talking about again? Big Al says, do y'all do Harry Potter cups? Yep, you can find quite a few of them on Jen's TikTok page. Usually the Marauders map, which she did quite a few of, but she also does house tumblers as well. Where'd you get your mask?
From Amazon. It's linked in my bio if you go to my webpage. There's a link on there that says coupon codes and affiliate links. I get them from Amazon, so they're right on there.
Papa Bear says, I need to live somewhere where there's more than just summer and hurricane season.
Yeah, I believe you.
Papa Bear, that's why we left Florida.
That's why
we couldn't handle
here.
It.
Carolinas.
The season, not having any seasons there screwed us up royally.
Hey guys, this is sloppy glitter because it's going to be a peekaboo with fireworks going off. I know
Alyssa,
that sounds weird, but this is glow-in-the-dark glitter.
Alyssa Osling says, so many years we couldn't tell each other's costumes because we were so bundled up.
Right? It is no fun being a northern kid at Halloween when it's costume time, unless you're having an indoor Halloween party. It's no fun.
Lonnie
it's not
Nixon
fun
says 6.4K more likes. You should be close.
Woo-hoo! All right, let me see how many we got.
Easy Designs 2018.
The question is, did we hit 200,000? Let me see. Let me see Green Hearts if you think we hit 200,000 likes. And let me see Skulls if you don't think we've hit 200,000 likes tonight.
Easy Design says, I'm from Northwestern PA. It snows 9 months out of the year.
Oh.
That wouldn't happen to be Erie, would it? Erie, PA?
Yeah, we used to go skiing there.
Mm-hmm.
Snow skiing. I like to visit the snow. I like to snow ski, although I haven't done it in 27 years, and I probably
just because
would kill
says,
myself if I tried it again, but...
Just because says, try 100 degrees plus in trick-or-treating.
You know, that's better than snow and sleet coming at you.
No, I don't know.
I think so.
I think both of those are just
They're both miserable.
Evil
They're miserable,
and miserable,
but I would rather be hotter than hell and go home and jump in a pool than freeze
Ooh.
Your ass off.
Lonnie Nixon said, would you like a peach cobbler drink recipe? No, but if you want to send me peach cobbler, you definitely can. one of my favorite desserts in the whole world.
My world. We have a dessert truck that comes in, a food truck, and we always get their peach cobbler. It's so good. So good.
Be Kind says, I grew up in Iowa. I had to wear my winter coat.
See? It's not fun. Tell
Nicole
me you,
Cumbie says,
I mean,
we only have to
fun.
Worry about rain. Well, that's because you live in a rainforest. Bree says, I live in Gainesville, Florida, and it literally rains every single day in
every
the
day?
Summer. Yep.
Every day.
For at least 15 minutes.
Yep.
And then it gets humid as all hell.
We got in the car to go to the beach the one day and it started raining and I'm like, maybe we should turn around. And
Sunny Hayes says,
like,
we have a chance of snow
no,
here.
Good.
Sunny
that's
Hayes says, we have a chance of snow
done.
Here Saturday.
Oh my God.
I'm in Wyoming. You must be in southern Wyoming because I think northwest Wyoming, isn't that mostly desert or rock steeps or whatever the heck they call it? So I know there's an area of Wyoming that... It doesn't get snow, but it still gets really cold. Oh my God, Susan Shelton says, we did Halloween weekend at Ocean Lakes this past weekend in Myrtle Beach.
Oh, I bet you that was awesome.
Oh my God, can you imagine doing trick-or-treating at Ocean Lakes?
I usually do.
Oh my God, because there's like 1,000 houses in like a 2-square-mile area.
Yeah, your kids must bank on the candy.
Right, everybody's giving green hearts.
That means that, because I told them green hearts if they, what was it? Shit, what did I ask? You were supposed to tell me about the green hearts earlier. The skeletons, Kirby's if course, they didn't
like
one
it. Can sliced peaches, one spice cake box mixed and together. Ooh. Is that like a hack for peach cobbler? See, peach
that?
Cobbler is one of the few things that I
put
took
that
from my
again.
Mother that I love.
Light again. Let's see how we glow after two. Go ahead. So these are going to have fireworks on them in those spots. So you'll see. I'll have to clean that up a little bit. Leave that off for a second.
Leave it off?
Yeah. Better. Okay. So we're gonna let this sit and then we'll epoxy it. Then it'll have decals that'll go over in the very specific colors to create some fireworks.
Easy Design says, yes, I live in Erie, PA.
Woo!
See? I knew, because we lived in Cleveland, and lake effect snow is a real thing.
Everybody's like, oh no.
Where'd y'all live in Florida?
4 inches, and then the lake effect area is like 14 inches.
We lived in West Palm for almost 2 years. Or Royal Palm. I'm Royal sorry. Palm, yeah. Royal Palm, which is right next to West Palm. Oops, North Florida just got a little better. They now have two Buc-ee's off of I-95 near Jacksonville's. What's a Buc-ee,
really?
Papa Bear?
I think it's like those it's like those Travelodge like we have on 71 going up, or 77 going up.
So Sunny Hays is 30 minutes from the Montana border, so that means you're in northern Wyoming, right? Northeastern Wyoming? Speaking of banking or candy, no one hands any out like when we were kids anymore.
Yeah, no. And you know you went back to those houses and gave you those full-size candy bars.
200K likes was for
Green Over
Hugs.
And over. Green, that's right, 200,000. Did we hit it? Did we hit it? We lost it on. I put my glasses on.
Fergie's Court says, yes, it's a cheat.
228,000 likes. You guys are freaking awesome. I wonder if we can hit 250, because I still have another tumbler or two to glitter.
Papa Bear, Mama Bear said to Papa Bear, hey, I bought a kolache. Jen loves kolaches.
Oh, kolaches. My mom makes them for me.
Sunny Hayes said, yeah, sure.
The raspberry jam ones, yep. And the peach.
So that's why you get snow 9 months out of the year.
Overwhelmed. All right, so let me spray this.
Aussie Dog says they don't do trick or treat in our area anymore. They have trunk or treats for the kids. Is that like, what is that?
You know how you see them set up over there at the pool, at the clubhouse?
Yeah.
And they all open up their trunks, and they decorate their trunks, and then they come through, the kids come through the parking lot, and they trick-or-treat, basically, from car to car. But they do it out of their trunk. Yeah. It's kind of a cute concept,
I thought it would
especially
have been,
for, like, apartments or
I thought it was kind of a way of
congregate to one area, or malls. They do it for malls.
Yeah, I thought it was more of a way of combining the two. So that it's fun for adults, too. So it's tailgating.
That's kind of what it is.
Is it?
It turns into that, yeah, basically.
Oh, see, now that would be fun.
Basically, yeah. And like,
did you finish the Saint Cups? Whitley B., it shipped.
Which one?
It shipped today, the Saints Cup.
It's gone.
You should have it in 2 days, I believe.
Butterfly Cup.
So you should have it by Saturday, I would think.
So pretty.
And the Butterfly Cup, yep.
I'm not butterfly, dragonfly.
I lied.
Carrie
White Lafferty says,
holy shit, it's a butterfly? It was supposed to be dragonflies. Did you freak out for just a second? Sorry about that.
Carrie White Lafferty said, I took candy from a trunk once. Didn't go so well. Laughing my ass off.
Right? All those things we tell our kids not to do. And what do? We send them trigger training out of people's trunks.
Whitley B says, it's not mine. I just wanted to see it.
Oh.
Yep.
Which one is it?
It shipped today.
Oh, yeah, it's
the Saints Cup.
So pretty. I do have a little tiny bit of that glitter left over.
Grizz Chick says mask.
Marked it. Saints, NOLA. A little bit of that left over. Yep.
Sean Overton, I used to trick or treat when I was a kid until 1:30 in the morning.
What?
They wouldn't allow us to do that around here.
People turn their lights off.
Tatted Thick Chick says, I go for the candy in the white vans.
The what?
The candy in the white vans.
Yeah.
Want some candy,
little girl? I used to do that to my daughter. I'd go to pick her up from school, and I'd roll down my way and go, want some candy, little girl? And she'd, Mom, I hate that voice. It's pretty funny. All right, we're gonna put some black around this.
Nicole Cumby said to add a thick chick, I'll watch your episode on Dateline.
You're so supportive, Megan. Thanks.
No, that was Nicole
Cumby. Oh, Nicole Cumby.
Thanks, Nicole. Saying it to Tatted Thick Chick. If you're taking candy from the white vans, I'll watch it on Dateline.
Yep. We'll catch the update then.
Oaks Pack, it's also fun to go house to house. If you live in an area where the houses are close. You know, when our kids were younger, we lived out in the country in Medina, Ohio. And it was a house about every half a mile.
Half a mile or so. And no sidewalks. Because you're on country roads and they do 55 miles an hour.
So we would always have to drive an hour to Jennifer's cousin's house who lived in a development. So that the kids could trick or treat in a development.
Yeah. Now those mom and dads that come around on the golf carts while their kids are trick or treating. Hell yeah. All right.
Susan Shelton says, I think people should hand out airplane bottles to the parents when taking their kids trick-or-treating.
Yes, they do in our neighborhood.
And we used to do it, too. We'd have a cooler out front filled with beers.
Yeah. And wine coolers and shit. We used to do that.
Shutterby says, hello, Jen, sweetie.
Hello.
And Mr. T.
All right, there's our black flame. It's going to go purple. Let's show them the glow purple, Mr. T. Sorry. I did that to you again. Take my mask off, though. Okay. Whoop, whoop! How amazing is that? Okay. This could be one of our giveaway cups. Because I made an extra.
Tracy McHenry says, we have a neighbor that gives out kettle corn and Jell-O shots for the adults. Nice. Now, that is an amazing neighbor.
Nice.
If I had a neighbor like that, I probably wouldn't be moving.
How many people TP'd the house and they gave out the little packages of like 5 pennies in it? So that was just rude when you were a kid.
Or they gave you an apple or something.
Yeah,
an apple
like,
or an
what
orange.
The hell?
You're like, what the hell is this?
I got a blue glitter ombre I gotta do. I haven't even spray painted it yet.
Bree says, you make some badass tumblers. I watch so many people, and you're the best, hands down.
Aw, thank you so much. I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
Corey
I love
said
what
it
I
too.
Do,
or so. Toothbrushes. There was always one person that gave out a toothbrush.
Come on.
You're like, come on.
Now,
seriously?
I know if you have a kid that's got an allergy or can't do the sugar, I get it. Those houses were always cool. They had alternatives.
Tanya, but, I know. She said, when I was younger, we used to have our candy x-rayed. All those urban myths about razor blades and drugs being in your candy.
That started with us.
You know what? I knew thousands of kids as I was growing up, and not one person ever found anything like that in their candy.
All right, we're doing a blue ombre. It's going to have a black mousse on it. So I've got Black Bear Glitters, Bear Necessities Collection, Randy's River. It's a really, really, really pretty, like lighter blue. This is Glitter Craze's Blue Jean Night. It's a soft denim blue. And then I've got Black Bear's Oops, a Navy, which is a really pretty, like, medium blue. It's probably one of the darker blues you're gonna get.
Francesca
and
says,
I do have a navy from BJ's. It's a little tiny bit left in there. It's a black and dark blue mix to make it look navy.
Francesca
so
said, who in the right mind would give away free drugs?
I know, that's what I'm thinking, right? You certainly aren't gonna put razor blades in them either.
Francesca says, no one wants to give away their drugs. Unicorn Rebellion. People next door to me did find needles 2 years in a row.
What? See, it's real. We've just never seen it. Let me get my sheets back.
Zero Skill Art says, moose are my favorite animal.
Oh, way cool.
Randa, you and Meraki Morning Boutique are my two favorite tumbler makers.
Aw.
Kayla Ash says, I want free herb.
Pretty awesome.
I know. If I knew somebody was giving away free herb on Halloween, I'd make sure I went to that house multiple times.
I'd buy 100 costumes just to keep changing my mask out. Just kidding, kids. Not good.
Papa Bear says,
say no to drugs.
Bane mask engage.
Yep.
Marijuana is not a drug. It's a weed.
It's a weed.
Carrie White Lafferty, sewing needles were found when I was growing up.
See, isn't that crazy?
Shutterby, we always had the neighbor's Halloween party because of food allergies. Always adult and kid yummies. Yeah, when you do stuff like that, that's awesome. Like somebody said, somebody gave out hot dogs on Halloween to feed people. That's great. But you don't give out an apple or an orange or a toothbrush.
Because
I would have been happy with hot dogs. I would have went back to that place probably like 6 times too.
Hell yeah. I don't want that far out.
Because I love hot dogs. Chili and cheese with jalapenos.
I'm a coleslaw and onion and mustard kind of person. Just on my hot dogs. It's the only time I like this stuff.
Oaks Pack said that was me. The person that was giving out the hot dogs.
Right? I'd be down for that. Alright. Let me go.
Jessica says, it's because the old people put their candy in the same blue container as their sewing kit.
And that's what happened. Some old person fucked it up one time.
Unicorn Rebellion, I haven't checked candy in years, to be honest. I know you have popular opinions, but still, LOL.
I know. We always scan through our kids, make sure if it was opened, we tossed it.
Yeah, or ate it ourselves, just to see what was in it. Cozy Corner says, off topic, but where did you get your mask you are wearing? I need one.
Amazon. If you go to my website, which is linked in my bio, and go to the affiliate coupon code page, you'll see them listed on there from Amazon. They're super, super comfortable. And they're washable, and you can change the filters out.
Or if anybody's giving away brownies on Halloween, I would go to that house multiple times, too. Chris, with all the antics, I only look at the candy for the candy packs, right?
Yeah.
Take out all the Snickers and the Reese's and give the rest back to the kids. Cajun Lady says, I do love your spray paint and glitter tip. I'm just amazed.
Yeah, it's just a lot easier to do. If I was spray painting a color, I would use it just like it were clear gloss.
A. Tomlinson said, wait, coleslaw on a hot dog?
Yeah, with some onions and mustard. I like coleslaw on my pulled pork sandwiches and my hot dogs. That's it.
That is Jen's favorite way of having a hot dog. We go to Sam's Corner every time we go to Myrtle Beach, at least once, because they've gotten so expensive over the years. And she always gets the same thing. A foot-long hot dog with coleslaw, onions, and mustard.
Yep.
And it is damn good.
Sure is.
Reggie Mama says, my kids always give me their Reese's. Apparently, quite a few people have never heard of coleslaw on a hot dog.
What?
Okay, Nicole Cumby says, I'm so over this game, I give up. Apparently, they're getting their asses beat now. Yep. A Case of Creation says, hot dog with chili and slaw. That's also very good.
I don't do the chili part, but yes, chili and slaw is very good. Like you can put chili with it, too. I don't do the chili. I'm not a chili person.
Francesca says we have to check my niece's candy because she's allergic to peanuts.
Eat it all. That makes total sense.
Ashley Perez says my fifth grade teacher lived a block away and she always handed out full-size candy bars to kids she knew.
How cool is that?
Shutterby says, same, send me, send me some brownies if you find them. I know, right? Anybody that's giving out brownies, you want to go back. We had a lady give out cash 1 year and gift cards another year for Halloween in our neighborhood. Susie Q.
I know. I mean, if it's last minute, you forgot it's Halloween. I get it.
Papa Bear said peach cobbler slices for Halloween.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I'd be there, too. I'd never leave.
Yeah.
They might have to call the cops to get me out of their house. I'm not a coleslaw fan either, though. I'm good with chili, cheese, and mustard.
Yeah, I like coleslaw, but it's not like my favorite. But I love it on a hot dog with, and I don't like raw onions either. But on a hot dog with coleslaw and some mustard, I love it.
Mama Jan says it's a southern thing for sure. Slaw dogs are the bomb. I love mustard, onion, and slaw. Always be kind of crafty.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about. It's good shit.
Only a Smith's hot dog. I like Nathan's. Nathan's hot dogs to me are just amazing. And if any of you, that's the thing with Sam's, and I don't know if they still do it. They used to deep fry their hot dogs. That's how they cooked them. They were stinking amazing. If you've never deep fried a hot dog, need to try it.
So good.
It is unbelievable.
So good.
I love Carolina Burger, slaw and chili. Yep. When my daughter was two, she would say, it's me, Destiny, instead of trick or treat. Hi, it's me, Destiny.
That's so cute.
Have you ever air fried a hot dog? Yeah, that's how we make them now.
Yeah, that's how we do it now.
We throw our hot dogs and our brats in the air fryer. Be Kind says, what cup is that?
This is it's gonna have a mousse on it. They asked for blue glitter with a black mousse on it. So we're doing a blue ombre and we're gonna put some trees on it and we're gonna pop a mousse in there.
Barb Duggan says, dang, now I want a hot dog.
I know, me too. I was just thinking, God, I can go for a hot dog.
Oh, yeah,
right now.
Francesca, air fryer hot dogs are amazing.
So good.
Because they stay juicy.
So good.
And they, they're just great. Throw them in your air fryer at 350 degrees for about 6 minutes, and they come out perfect. A little crispy on the outside and perfectly cooked in the middle. If you're doing brats, put them in for 350 for 8 minutes. Homemade turkey burgers are definitely good. And if you've some people will put them, will bake them in the oven, because we used to bake our turkey burgers in the oven. Also, throw those in the air fryer. They come out so stinking juicy, it's amazing. Yep, pizza rolls. I fried pizza rolls before. Deep fried them, but I also like them in the air fryer. Hot dogs are one of my favorites with mac and cheese on the side. That's Jen's favorite.
Working that color down, layering as we go.
Halen Ramuson says something. I want hot dogs. Lorraine says gorgeous. Daza said I just love this song. Shutterby says air fryer for everything. Mine's used every day for years.
Oh,
so do
God,
we.
Yeah.
We use ours every day. Reheating pizza, amazing.
Everything.
Hot dogs, sausage. The only thing I don't really use it for probably is bacon. I like baking my bacon in the oven. Kathy 1812 says, what are you spraying?
Clear Gloss.
Kraft mac and cheese with hot dogs mixed in, my favorite. Oh, I know. That was a kid's staple when we were growing up in the 80s.
Oh, yeah.
Kraft macaroni and cheese and hot dogs.
Are you a Gen Xer?
Mr. T, love your glitter color. Miss T, love your glitter colors.
Thank you.
Steaks are awesome in the air fryer. Wendy, I've never tried a steak in the air fryer.
Never done that.
Oven bacon is the best way to cook bacon. I know, I agree 100%.
Yes, absolutely.
2617 Rams.
Oh, my God. What the hell?
I loved Kraft macaroni and cheese from the box. I just love the buttery taste of it. And, I mean, I grew up on that stuff. Jen went to the dollar store today looking for some stuff for the sub box.
Packing stuff.
Some packing stuff for the sub box. And they have Cheetos macaroni and cheese in the box. And she bought 3 boxes of it. So we're going to try that. And it's cheddar jalapeno.
Yep.
Oh. Hot dog with a piece of cheese stuck in the middle and wrapped with bacon deep fried. I've seen that.
That's amazing.
Yeah, that looks amazing. We've never tried it. Now, what we have done
are the jalapeno
wrapped
with bacon.
And you can wrap those around a sausage as well, or a hot dog. You just slice it and then put the jalapeno back around the hot dog, wrap it with bacon, and bake the whole thing together. Oh, those are amazing, too. Chris Chick says, I have to get to sleep. 3 a.m. is way too early.
Woo!
Thank you for joining in, hon.
Thank you for joining us.
Tedded Thick Chick. Mix a red box and an orange box of the Cheetos mac and cheese. Yeah, she got one of the red boxes too.
I did.
That's the Flamin' Hot.
Yeah. It's so amazing. This ombre, I'm not gonna lie, this ombre is badass. We're gonna touch it up a little bit, but damn, it's good.
Francesca says, my girlfriend eats her hot dogs with a slice of American cheese like a burger. Yeah, see, I can't do American cheese on a hot dog. It has to be either like a queso or a cheddar cheese on my hot dog. Chris Chick said, love you all. Tracy McHenry said, I didn't like the Cheetos macaroni and cheese. We haven't tried it yet. So I'm hoping it's good.
Keep bringing in and blending up. I got another layer to do on that lighter color.
Cheese whiz on a hot dog is good. Yeah. Cheese whiz I could do.
I haven't bought cheese whiz, though, the canned cheese whiz.
Right.
And forever.
Big Al, do you know hot dogs take 38 minutes off your life? Yep, and I've probably lost about 3,800 minutes just in the last 2 months, and I'm okay with that.
But adds like 5 points of joy to your character sheet.
5 points of joy to your character sheet. Jen just made this into an RPG.
I did. Took away some hit points for eating the damn shit, but you got joy out of it. So.
I hope that's not true, Big Al, because our kids, when they were growing up, lived on macaroni and cheese and hot dogs.
Because they liked it, and they ate it, and it was cheap.
Uh-oh, Susan said, that tastes bad. We had it. Doesn't taste like hot Cheetos. You guys are killing me here.
Oh, no.
Because I have high expectations. Sorry. Trina Mama Bear,
my
three cups.
My nephew will
says,
eat it. He'll eat anything.
Beautiful. I love the colors. It looks amazing. Great job.
Thank you. We're kind of doing almost like a nice
Dog Boy Brewery said, I'm dead then. 38 minutes off of every hot dog he's eaten.
Right?
Baby Girl says, that's so pretty. Big Al says, yeah, so did I. Fire roasted jalapeno stuffed with Gouda and bacon. And I don't think it's supposed to be Muslim, because I think that would be illegal to stuff those with Muslims.
Yeah, you don't want to do that.
Unicorn Rebellion, I add hot fries to my Kraft mac and cheese. Mm. Jen likes, it's not her favorite, but she likes it. Macaroni and cheese with broccoli and bacon on the top of it. Hubby still asks for KD and hot dogs for dinner.
Alexa, next.
Lorraine says, I do not care about the 38 minutes. It's good. Right? Who doesn't like hot dogs? Papa Bear says, Grandmaster Blender at it again. Beautiful.
It's going to be really pretty, I think. I want to bring this lighter color up a little bit because I got to do some trees and a mousse on there. So I want it to...
Coast pack. My kids live on waffles, cereal, mac and cheese, PB&J, chewy granola bars, and cola.
And you know what? Your kids are happy.
Our kids lived on pretty much the same except for the cola part.
Our grandkids eat very natural, whole, good food, healthy foods, very little sugars on it, and I love that too.
Oh, mushrooms, not Muslims. Mushrooms.
Mushrooms.
Okay, that makes more sense because I don't think any of the Muslims would appreciate us putting them in a jalapeno.
All
but that sounds
last
amazing.
Last blend is going to be our blue in the middle here to blend up these two.
We make a jalapeno stuffed, bacon wrapped hors d'oeuvre. And what you do is you ground Italian sausage, mix it with some cream cheese, some green onions, and then you stuff the jalapeno with that and wrap it with bacon and bake it in the oven at 350 for about 20 minutes until the bacon's done. And oh my God, talk about heartburn, but they are so stinking good. Sean Overton said, I ate 13 hot dogs in a contest at the Washington Town and Country Fair years ago. Yeah, I couldn't do that for...
I was going to say, all those hot dog eating contests. I was going to say, my God.
Francesca says, but what about pizza toppings? Where do we stand on that?
Mm.
Pizza toppings. Okay. So let's see. Jen's favorite pizza is pepperoni, sausage, and mushroom. But she likes the bubbles in the crust. So if there's a bubble in the crust, she's going to take that first before anything else. She also likes Hawaiian pizza.
Where's my other bubble crust, folks?
She likes Hawaiian pizza, pineapple, ham, but she likes to throw jalapeno on it. Me, I'll pretty much eat anything on a pizza but anchovies. And it's always got to have jalapenos on it. But I do probably my...
You do like the...
My
you don't
favorite.
Like black olives, though.
Yeah, I don't like black olives. Black olives are overpowering on a pizza. But I love black olives, just not on a pizza. But my go-to is always going to be a New York pepperoni and cheese. Because you can't go wrong with that.
Zero Skill Art says, I ate 21 hot dogs with buns at a Little League party.
Aubrey Matt!
Oaks Pack says, I love
freaking
the bubbles.
Awesome.
I love crust bubbles.
Me too. Me too. It's my favorite part.
Chris with all the antics says, yes, bubbles in the crust.
Yeah.
Francesca, I'm a bubble crust pizza person.
Right? It's the first piece you grab. It's the bubble crust.
Ryan says, I have to go shower. I got pumpkin all on my face and head. Oh, that must be in the video.
Uh-oh.
I wonder if that's what he's alluding to. Shutterby says, yes, bubble.
Right?
Corey says, that sounds amazing. I hate anchovies.
Yeah, me too.
I'm literally eating pizza right now. Amber Beebi. Vanessa says, I don't like mushrooms. Cooking pizza right
now. I like
her. Lorraine B, I have to eat the crust. It's drenched in garlic butter. And that's the great thing about Papa John's is their garlic butter for dipping that crust in. Oh, my God.
So good.
That is amazing.
So good.
Hallie Rammusen says, I hate the bubbles in the crust. I don't like
really?
Them either. I'm not a big fan of them.
I love it.
Tatted Thick Chick says, Alfredo sauce instead of red chicken, red onion, spinach, mushrooms, bacon, and feta. Life-changing. Trina Mama Bear, my mom put green or black olives in egg salad. Okay, now, that's a different story. Now,
salad,
if you want to know
salad.
The right... Now, I'm not talking egg salad. In egg salad, yeah, you should put green olives in egg salad. If you're making...
Mr. Turtle, where are the paper towels?
If you're making potato salad
perhaps
and you're not
today.
Putting green olives in your potato salad, you're missing out where massively. And also, don't make mustard potato salad. That's not real potato salad. I have to give you one.
Oh, I thought you brought them out.
Nope.
Goofball! You goofball! Just sealing it. I don't want it to move. I'm going to boxy it. It's going to be beautiful.
Beautiful.
And for those of you that are fighting me back and forth now on the yellow mustard in your potato salad, unless you've had my potato salad, you really can't fight.
I'm going to wash my hands. And then I'm almost done, so we're going to go to Q&A.
All right, so Jen's going to wash her hands, and then she'll be back, and she's going to do some Q&A because we're going to be wrapping it up. But getting back to the potato salad thing, oh, my God. It is so good. If you want the recipe or my recipe, I'll give it to you. You just got to email Jen for it.
We share my mom's recipe. I'm just
it is amazing. Oh my God, it is
our
so creamy.
Like
but the other thing is too, you have to use Hellman's mayonnaise with it. Any other type of mayonnaise, not gonna work. Got to be Hellman's. I like it with or without mustard. Mustard's a northern thing, mustard's a southern thing, right? Mustard in your potato salad?
A little bit of mustard in ours too, just to give it the...
Yeah, I don't put mustard in mine.
It's a kick. I'm trying to get the...
Is it loaded baked potato salad? No, it's not, but I also have an amazing recipe for German potato salad. Oh my God. And I haven't made that in eons.
Oh my God, it looks
yeah, southern is with mustard.
Oh, it's some kielbasa and pierogies.
Yeah.
Some of that.
Oh my God. German potato salad made with vinegar, kielbasa, red potatoes, onion, green onion. Oh my God. Loaded baked potato pizza. I've never heard of that. Okay, redeeming quality of the brand. I'm pretty sure southern because everyone around me cakes mustard. Yeah. Mustard in potato salad is not good. I've never bought Hellman's. Seriously? If you're making sandwiches, always go with Miracle Whip. If you're making a potato salad, you should always use Hellman's. If you're just cooking with it, Duke's. That's at least I do all the cooking here. All of it. I love breakfast pizza with sausage. Oh my God, sausage gravy breakfast pizza. That sounds amazing. What am I doing? You're telling me to what? I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing.
Did you go over the cup for the micro cup? I want to get followers so we can finish that up. And then what else do we need to cover?
I don't know. That's why I said I don't know what this means.
Sorry.
This is like I thought you were being Ezekiel Elliott and saying feed me.
Feed me. Give me the ball. Ezekiel Elliott. Mr. T, dropping some mayo knowledge. I love cooking, or at least I used to. And I used to make a shit ton of cheesecakes, all different kinds. That used to be my go-to, too. Let's see. All right, so for the giveaway drawing, for those of you that are still with us, for the giveaway drawing, which we will probably be doing on Saturday, what you need to do is you need to follow Lahanu, hopefully who's still on here. She'll give you a message here real quick. You need to follow her, and you need to comment on any of the videos on her page and tag me, Mr. Thirsty Turtle. And I have no idea where my sign is. Where's that, Green?
Right where your left hand is. Reach right in.
Oh, it's in here? Oh, it's on the side. Yeah, and tag me, at Mr. Thirsty Turtle. Okay? So, follow Lahanu, because we're trying to get them up to 1,000 followers so that we can do a dual live with zero. Follow them, comment on any of their videos, and tag me in the video. And that will get you entered into the drawing for Saturday. And my understanding, according to Jen, is we're going to be giving away more than one. Probably more than 2 tumblers on Saturday. Let me see here. I'm going to steal Jen's glasses. Maple bacon cheesecake. Lemon raspberry cheesecake. Yeah, I'm not a big maple bacon fan. I used to make a white raspberry cheesecake. White chocolate raspberry. I've also done turtle cheesecakes. Brownie cheesecakes. Regular cheesecakes. Oreo cheesecakes. I've done a lot of them. Repeat that, please. I was still talking about mayo. Follow Lahanu. Lahanu. L-A-H-A-N-U. Her son is zero. We're trying to get them up to 1,000 followers so that we can do a dual live with them. Okay? So we can be on with zero. So follow them. Comment on any of the videos on their page and tag me in it. At Mr. Thirsty Turtle. That's how I'm going to know that you've been there, you followed them, and that will get you entered into the drawing on Saturday. Okay? At Mr. Thirsty Turtle. Let's see. Pumpkin cheesecake, yep. I've made a lot of those. I cook too, Mr. Turtle. Sometimes I love to cook. I used to love to cook when all the kids were here. Now I don't like cooking for 2 or 3 people. It's kind of silly to me. Pumpkin cheesecake, yep. I'm hoping to do my first video tomorrow. Outstanding Zero Skill Art. Tag us on it. Tag us on it. All right. What do we got left here, Green?
I think I'm done with at least the tumblers.
Can you spell the name? I can do better. Oh, Lahanu. L-A-H-A-N-U. Lahanu. Red Velvet Cheesecake. Yep, I've made those too.
Those are your best.
That's the one that Jen likes the most, and my daughter-in-law.
Yeah.
We have 6 kids, so our meals are huge. Yeah, see, I can't cook for 2 people. Like, I made Brussels sprout pasta the other day.
To feed 12.
And I made enough to last, like, 3 days. Brussels sprout pasta is awesome, too. So, Jen wants to know what kind of designs you want to see her make on here.
More inks, more glitter, more powder.
More
brushes,
inks, more glitter. Drizzles,
more what? Unique, different, clay.
Unicorn Rebellion says, I have 4 boys. I can feed an army with what they eat. Right. LOL. Yeah, we know how that goes too.
We have a nephew that we can feed an army.
Broccoli salad is a big hit here. Yeah, Jen loves broccoli salad.
It's one of my favorites.
Question. How much would it be if I got a cup that has a picture of my cat on it? It would be $0, unfortunately, because Jen doesn't do those types of tumblers. She doesn't do pictures of people or pictures of pets. It's kind of a block in her brain, and she can't make it work to a level that she is satisfied with. But we can give you a bunch of other tumbler makers that do those types of tumblers. And that are very good at it. inks, more glitter. Morgan leather. That could have been more glitter. And it was just glitter everything. Wood greens or a watercolor alcohol ink. Power wash, glitter, clay, anything. Love the power wash ones. Dips in anything from her head.
What?
Anything that you can come up with. They just love to see it.
All right.
Sam, I want to see her do one with clay. Yeah, she doesn't do a lot with clay.
You think I'm not a very good clay artist?
She thinks she's not a good clay artist, but everything she does turns out amazing, so she could do clay. All right, so Jen's going to wrap it up with some Q&A, and then remember to check us out Saturday night at 8:30 p.m. We're going to be making an amazing drink, an adult beverage, and you will be able to make this one, of course, without the alcohol. You do not have to make the drink, of course. You can drink whatever you want, but we're going to start off by making an adult beverage. So, Jen's going to come back in here, do some Q&A, and then we're going to shut it down for the night, folks. We appreciate y'all being here. Let's get Jen over here so that she can do Q&A, and then we will see you guys on Saturday night at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Some Q&A's. Bring it a little closer. Hi. See better. Is it hard to make tumblers? There are some styles that are pretty easy. There's some techniques that are much easier to do than some of the more advanced ones. That's weird. I'll check to see if I need to refollow you, but it shouldn't. Where did you get the straw topper at? I'm not sure which straw topper, but I usually make my own straw toppers. Oh, maybe the silicone one you were talking about. Pricing all depends on size and design. Oh, thank you, Sean. I appreciate that. Yeah, we're going to be working on that one, the white and black one. Where'd it go? Where did Mr. T put it? We're going to be working on this one. We're going to be putting some glitter in these spots. So we're going to take each one of these sections and put different glitter in there. I think it's going to be pretty cool. It's going to take a while, but I'm going to use it as my therapeutic cup. And we're just going to glitter all these different. I wanted it to be kind of like a coloring book so we could pick our own colors and then use our little fine tip glitter applicator and apply glitter into each of these sections. And I think it would be kind of neat. So I'm going to need you guys to help me pick out some colors. Probably gonna need a few so I don't have too many bouncing up and touching each other. Any tips for beginners? Pick a style or two that you're really excited about and learn how to do that technique and learn how to do it really good. Then move on to the next one. It helps with keeping expenses minimal because you're buying what you need for that technique and getting really good at it. And then you can start to grow your collection as you're ready to go to the next one. And then post when you're ready to sell. If you are just starting brand new with tumblers, you're probably not quite ready to sell yet, so take some time to kind of perfect your technique before you sell. Because the worst thing is for tumbler makers that are out there that are doing this as a business, as a full-time income, is they get really excited because they purchase a tumbler from somebody and they're expecting it to be of an experienced tumbler maker and they get it and it's not. So price appropriately. Don't expect to charge $50, $60, $70 for a tumbler that you just learned how to make, meaning like you just started making them. Post a lot, try to take really good pictures, professional pictures, and have patience. Don't compare yourself to other tumbler makers because you're not going to grow at the same rate as them. You're not going to sell the same things as them. You're going to reach different markets, some of the same markets too, but have fun. If you stop having fun, then take a break because it's easy to get burned out. How do you sand without leaving marks? sanding like the rims of the cups, we use a flap wheel.
This one's beat up and it's gotta be replaced, but we use it on our Dremel. It's a flap wheel and it goes right on the, it comes all straight. It won't have this groove in it. You have to make the groove from doing your rims, but you just set it on there and rim it around at least twice and give it a good clean rim. Otherwise, standing the outside of the cup, I use a sanding block. Oh, maybe bright colors or for fall, like Christmas or all our New Year's colors. That would be really neat. I think that would be kind of cool. I was almost thinking maybe I might just have to make another one. I want to make one with neon colors. Really bright neon colors, because I think it would just be really cool with that black offset. I think it would be neat. Blank bottom. I've not been able to get rubber bands to go this way to try to do a plaid. I can't get them to stay. I need a bigger cup. Rainbow colors, that would be pretty cool. Use different blues as a calming cup. Oh, I like that idea. Looks like string of lights. That would be really neat. You know, you could make a Christmas cup with a string of lights like that. That would be a good idea. Well, I hope you guys had fun hanging out with us tonight. We're so glad you're here. If you're not already following me, make sure you hit the plus sign and give me a follow. We hit 254,000 likes tonight, which is amazing. Not sure we got pushed to the For You page, but we'll work on it. We'll get back to it. Getting banned sucks. It's hard to get your way back to that page when you get banned. Blue ombres, that would be cool. It would be really kind of neat to do an ocean too, to do like sand and, but geometrically, it'd be kind of neat. I don't know, there's a lot of possibilities, so you're probably gonna have to make a few of them. All right, any final questions before we call it a night? I'm exhausted. We've got about 45 custom cups left, and they're all moving quickly. So you will start to see, if you're waiting for a custom cup, it'll be coming soon, super soon. I was on your For You page, awesome. Yeah, it just depends on how, like if we get a bunch of taps, a bunch of likes, and a bunch of people commenting, sometimes we get pushed to the For You page and we'll stay on there for a little while and that'll draw in a crowd, but it's getting kind of late. Love you too, Papa Bear. You guys are awesome. All right, guys, if you don't know, we do upload all of our TikTok replays to YouTube, so check that out. I'm almost caught up. I think I have two left to get caught up besides tonight. So check that. If you missed a live replay, it's okay. You can catch us on there. Saturday, make sure you join us, 8:30 p.m. Eastern time. We're going to make a beverage, and then we'll start on tumblers. We're going to have a couple cups to give away on Saturday night. I'd really like to get them done and out of here. Awesome. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much. Have a great night.